Hi everyone, welcome. I tried to play an intro there, it didn't really work. Hi everyone, welcome to the 20,000 subscriber party. Welcome, welcome, welcome. I don't know if you got to see the intro. Could you guys see the intro or not? I'm not sure. We gonna celebrate, everyone. We gonna celebrate. That's right. Thank you very much. I dressed up all for you guys. That's right. So welcome, everyone. Welcome. Thank you very much. I'm feeling a little fresh. Feeling a little fresh. Different outfit for every 10,000 subscribers. How about that? Awesome, awesome. Glad to have you here. I'm going to cut up this cake into 20,000 little pieces and mail it to all of you. So we're going to go from there. All right. All right. So if you guys have any cake or anything, let me light this guy up. Ouch, you're going to hurt myself. I'm going to light this guy up. Light this guy up here. Ouch. All right, gonna light that guy up. Anybody want to make a wish? Oh, even before that, let me turn on the main camera. I didn't turn on the main camera yet. Turn on the main camera here. Just making sure that's okay here. Record that. All right. For 20,000. Yes. 1/20,000th of the small cake. You'll have like a little piece like this big. All right, we're going to sing a 20,000 song. Happy 20,000 to you. I'm still sick. It's okay. Okay, everyone make a wish, quick. Everyone make a wish. Gonna blow it out. Your wish is her. Okay, make a wish. Wish you 30,000. Thank you very much, Porter. Thank you very much. 1 million subs. See, Julia's reaching a little bit higher. A real bit higher. Okay, here we go. We're not gonna blow out this candle here. 20,000 wishes. Thank you very much, everyone. Here we go. And blow. All right, set off the fire alarm. All right. Awesome, awesome. Thank you very much, guys. Thank you. Thank you very much. Okay, I'm going to give this to my lovely wife who's actually standing by here. Okay, she's going to maybe cut me a piece and bring it down for me. And maybe we will eat it live. So, and looking at the chat here, thank you all for the awesome wishes here. Thank you. Sponsored by Sharpie from Nathan. Thank you. That's awesome. Oh, scream out 20,000. I missed that. 20,000! Like Mortal Kombat, right? 20,000! Fernandez, 1 million in 2017. Well, that's very ambitious. Ambitious, maybe. So, you might wonder why I'm celebrating so much for 20,000. Mainly because this was my goal when I finished off last year. When I finished off last year, I said to myself I wanted to hit 10,000 by my birthday, which I reached a little bit later. I reached around August. 10,000, and then I wanted to reach 20,000 by the end of the year. I'll admit, when it was around maybe July, I thought it might be a little bit, overreached. But you know, it is what it is. But 20,000—that's why I'm celebrating today. And I want to thank all of you guys for, you know, all of you for subscribing and, you know, following along. I know we're all in this art journey together, and you know, for following along and going on your own art journey. You know, it's really cool to see everyone here trying to reach out for their dreams. So I appreciate all that, and thank you each and every one of you. Like you know, I wish I could reply to every single comment you guys leave. I feel really bad when I can't reply to every single comment, but I do read all of them, and I want to thank all you guys for the great, you know, the great comments you've been giving me and the support and all of that. So really, really means a lot to me. So from the bottom of my heart, thank you all. Thank you all for subscribing. Thank you all for saying it's worth your time to be alerted of my content, for wanting to follow my content. Really, really means a lot to me. And thank you all for joining the stream tonight. Well, you know, we're going to have a lot of fun tonight. We said we're going to draw Baby Groot and Rocket Raccoon tonight. I thought we might as well do a full drawing tonight. That's why we won't do a challenge. But yeah, so I thought it would be a lot of fun. No champagne. I actually don't drink. But I do have a nice bottle of Diet Coke here. That's another sponsor I would love, a Diet Coke. So grab, everyone grab their glass. Everyone grab their glass. We're all going to have a sip of Diet Coke here. Okay. Nothing like celebrating 20,000 then with a little bit of aspartame. All right. Cheers to 20,000 of you. Cheers to all of you, all 20,000 of you. Thank you again for all the support. It means a lot to me. Salute. Diet Coke for all. Cheers. Cheers. Yeah, all right. I spilled already. That's great. That's okay. If I don't finish this, I'll just pour it on top of me at the end, okay? That's good. We will do that at the end. All right. All right. Cheers. Cheers, everyone. Cheers. So let's have some fun, guys. Let's have some fun. Sponsored by Mountain Dew. Not Mountain Dew. Not Mountain Dew. I kind of like Mountain Dew. It's good. Maybe the Diet Mountain Dew. Right on. So just quickly looking at the chat here. Just quickly looking at the chat, and I want to thank all of you guys for joining in tonight. There's about 50 of you online tonight. Thank you so much for joining in at the beginning. we're going to have a lot of fun tonight. So, again, tonight's a free-for-all, guys. It's a free-for-all. This is your chance to ask me any type of question that you want, any advice you want me to give. I am in the mood to give advice tonight, so we'll see. Mythbusters, probably not continuation because... first of all, it's gigantic, and I really wanted to do something that's from start to finish tonight, so that's what we are going to do tonight. So to let you guys know, we'll probably go for roughly around, let's say 2 hours. 2 hours to get it done, depending, but you guys are a lot of fun to talk to for sure, so I will love to do it for you. Kane wants me to say spaghetti meatballs and chocolate sauce. Yum. Yum. I love all of that stuff. Maybe not together, but all the All right, and here comes the questions. Here comes the questions. So this is what we're going to do. I'm just going to take about a couple minutes just to answer some of your questions, and then we will go into it. Now, again, so I'll time this, okay? Because, you know, I get all wrapped up in answering your questions because I love answering your questions. So with that, we'll just take a couple minutes, answer a few questions, then we will actually get into the actual drawing. So if I'm not drawing by 10:30 p.m. Eastern time, which is around 7:30 Pacific time, if I'm not drawing by 10:30, you tell me, hey, start drawing, okay? Okay, so I will try to quickly go through as many questions as I can here. Okay, so let's start off with Dylan Lewis Gaming. How do you improve your arts? Okay, of course, the age-old answer is practice. Lots and lots and lots of practice. Your sketchbook and your pen should be like your knife and your fork. Carry it around everywhere and draw everything. Draw everything, not just what you see in a comic book, not just pictures you see on the internet. Draw everything. Draw from life. Draw from life and try to understand. That's even more important. Try to understand. So if you're trying to understand an anatomy, when you're seeing, for example, seeing someone smiling, for example, when I'm smiling here, right? A lot of things are going on in the face here. We got skin that's being pulled back here. We got muscles that are contracting, all of that stuff. If you learn how all that stuff it works, then a lot of that, you know, a lot of that will help you when it comes to drawing, okay? If you have a full understanding how that stuff will go, okay? So that's a very short answer to a very long answered question. So, okay, James Hunsker asks, what would be the best way to learn anatomy? Try to take life drawing classes. That would be great if you could get into some life drawing classes. And, of course, books. Can't go wrong with books. One of my favorite books is Artistic Anatomy. That's one of the great books out there. I'm sure you can find it somewhere online, something like that. But anatomy books would be best. Can you draw a manga character? I would, but I'm not very good at it. I'm not very good at it. And the proof of that is the dislikes I got on my Pokemon drawing, okay? So I'm not the best at manga characters, but hopefully I'm getting better. Martin Guerrero asks, have you ever considered making your own superhero? Absolutely. I mentioned this before. I am currently working on my own IP, which I'm not releasing till about 2018 on my birthday. So June 2018, I am going to release my own IP. I can't mention anything about it right now. I'm still in development, but yes, I have my own superheroes in mind. Roar of Death asks, how long have you been drawing? Ever since I was 2. I did not consider it professionally until my last year of high school. So that would be 1997, okay? And then we go from there, all right? Stereo Gamer asks, what's your favorite color to use? I like using all of them. I love using all the colors, but might as well say light blue pencil. Number one question that I get is, which is this pencil? So I'll answer that right now. A Pilot Color Eno Lead. Pilot Color Eno Lead. So that is My favorite. Rosaku says, have you played any video games? I stopped playing a long time ago, mainly because of the time. I used to play a lot before, but now I'm more into looking at like concept art and how the games are put together as opposed to actually playing them, just because I could spend 12 hours playing a game. So I really stopped playing video games. So let's see, 2 hours worth your time, Brian? I hope so. Thank you very much. Devin says, consent to me. I'm not sure what you want me to consent to. Dwarf GT says, do you have any tips for digital art? I want to get started and really want to know. That is a huge subject to cover because everyone has their different methods. I have my own different methods, so I'm hoping to start doing some digital art tutorials maybe in the new year, but that we'll see. AJM says, now we have to do a celebration for 2076. Well, we'll call this one, I'll include that all together. Draw a manga character. It wouldn't make my day. I will do it in an American style. How about that? Darth Art says, I'll draw you with man at arms. Okay, sure. Thanks. James says, I can't do hands and feet. Sorry, hold on. I went all the way straight down. So, hold on. What time is it? It's 20. I got 2 minutes left. I lost my place. I apologize. Okay, all right, there you go. Can't do hands and feet too well and wear the torso and hips meet, James. That's everyone has a lot of problems with that. Check out my artistic anatomy or my superhero anatomy that might help you with the torso and the hips. Hands and feet, I'll see if I can work in a tutorial or two in the new year, okay? Michael, did I go to college for art? Yes, I did. I took technical illustration way back 1997. That was a 3-year course, graduated in 2000. And then I took computer animation. That was in 2007. And then I worked in film. PJ May says, so what's the next big goal? We will see. I was hoping to do a little bit more ambitious for the next year, maybe 50,000 by my birthday, 100,000 by the end of the year. That might be a bit ambitious, but we'll see. Like, I thought this was ambitious for this year, but it wasn't too bad. So, Comic Kid has school tomorrow, but whatever. It's okay. It's the holidays, all right? Fernando says, James, been a while. Congratulations. Thank you so much. Carson says, when did I start to draw? Again, I think I answered this before, but I started drawing when I was two, not professionally till end of high school, okay? I got a minute left, guys, and then I got to really start drawing. Porter says, please tell me every single thing in making a comic from drawing to paint, putting in the words. Not right now. Okay. Go check out my How to Be a Comic Book Artist series, Porter, if you haven't already. That should help. Okay. RIP school, all right. Brian, no sleep. When will I see Rogue One? Christopher asks. I'm seeing it tomorrow night. Tomorrow night at 10:40. Maybe I'll jump on live afterwards just to tell you how much I loved it, okay? All right. Nathan wants me to draw Mickey Mouse, maybe one of these days for sure. Maybe just a couple more questions here, guys. Potato Prince asks, how do you balance your art life and your other things for somebody not doing professionally? It's tough. I'll guarantee it's tough. That's why you try to combine them. You see if you could combine your art life and your personal life, but it's really, really tough. It's all about have a plan, have an end goal. And then the planning out gets a little easier if you have an actual end goal. If you don't have a goal in mind, then it's really tough. It's really tough. But that's the first thing. Find out what you actually want to achieve with your art, then make a goal, set a deadline, and then work backward from there. That's my suggestion. Okay, Hado, I just answered that question, so hopefully you heard that. Kane asked, do you like draw with Jazza and Mark Creeley? They are my heroes. They are my heroes. As you know, me and Jazza are friends. Maybe I'm hoping, hopefully, to go to Australia if not next year, the year after. I'm planning that so me and Jazza can do some carpool karaoke, for example. Mark Creeley just tweeted me today saying congratulations. So Mark Creeley is the man. So guys, we are going to go ahead. You guys here have a lot of questions here, so we will I should start drawing. It's already 10:30. So I'm just quickly running through here. quickly running through here. So again, welcome everyone. There's about 70 of you online right now. So this is what we're going to do, okay? Like always, whenever I do my live stream, I always film it as if I'm going to do a tutorial. So it's like I'm doing like a little masterclass for you guys. So I'm gonna try to teach you guys, or at least tell you guys my thought process when I'm actually drawing. And then when I go into the time-lapse area, that is when I'm going to go back to the chat and I'm going to answer as many questions as I can. Again, thank you so much for joining in to the fun tonight. If you missed the cake before, I'm hoping my wife will come down and bring me some cake. You know, maybe the slice of cake, maybe I'll try to eat that in like 20 seconds. Maybe we'll try to do something like that. Okay, so feel free to draw whatever you like during this session. If you want to have it in the background as white noise, please do. In the meantime, let me just turn on some music here so it won't be completely silent, at least. Okay, just let me know if the music is too loud. All right, but we are going to get going. And again, thank you guys for just quickly running through the rest of them. Thank you all for the wonderful comments and the words of support. Really means a lot to me. You guys are amazing. You guys are amazing, amazing. You think my drawings are amazing. You guys are amazing. Thank you so much. And I'm sure all of you have a really bright future when it comes to art. Another cheers to you. Salute to you. Salute to you. This is sponsored by Diet Coke. This session, this drawing session, is sponsored by Diet Coke. Ow. All right, so Huddle Gaming, that music is for you, okay? Let's get the party going. Woo! Let's have some fun. I'm going to turn on this up here. Okay. So... okay, so again, I can't stop looking at this chat. This chat, you guys are so much fun. I love looking at these chats. I love talking to you guys. Okay, so usually, guys, again, what happens is I will block the chat. I will block the chat, so I won't, when I'm actually doing the initial drawing here, I can't see what you guys are talking about, so feel free if you guys want to answer each other's questions. Like, I have subscribers who are with me ever since I started this channel, and a lot of new subscribers in the past month or so. So, I won't dump the Coke on the paper, Tia Hero. Don't worry about it. Okay, so please answer each other's questions. Please be civil. Okay. Also, point out if anyone's being a loser, let me know. I'm gonna ban them. Okay. So let's keep everything civil here. Also, let you guys know I do have a lot of kids that follow me as well. So let's also try to keep it a little PG, okay? It would help a lot. Okay. Oh, okay. Can you hear anything? Okay, just make sure you guys can hear me okay. Somebody can't say they can't hear anything. Okay, greetings everyone, greetings. Just give me an okay that you can hear me before I go in, okay? Yep, you can hear me? All right. And the music's not too loud? The music's not too loud? Hey, you know that, we call that, maybe the Diet Coke was a bad idea. Me got me some gas. All right, this is going to be a very interesting tutorial, I'm telling you that much. All right, you can't hear the music, okay, because I don't want to, you want to bring the music up, is that better? Can you hear the music now better? Let me know. All right. Yeah. Okay, it's good now? Better? Okay, music's better? All right. Cool. Let me know if it's too loud. All right? All right. I actually can't hear the music. I turned it off on my side because I want the audio from the main camera not to be thing. So. By the way, the music is, it's royalty-free music I got, so... hopefully I won't get banned on YouTube here, but it's all very, like, inspirational music and all that kind of stuff, right? So, all right, guys, so right now, I am going to go ahead and cover the chat. All right, and I'm gonna go into this like I'm doing a tutorial. Again, if I don't answer your questions, that's why I'm not answering your questions. So I'm gonna start off with the blue line. I'll try to go a little bit darker because I know people don't wanna get, you know, sometimes you can't see exactly what I'm doing. So I'll try to go as dark as I can with the blue line so you guys can see. And then once I go into time lapse, I'm coming back to the chat. All right, so let's do this. I've been wasting a lot of time, 20 minutes. I've been just yapping, okay? Bye, Fernandez. Thanks a lot. Okay. All right, guys. I'm covering the chat right now. All right. Covering the chat right now. Okay, so chat is covered, so I cannot talk to you guys right now. But hopefully, I got gas. I got gas. Hold on. It's a good thing I don't have the microphone up to my mouth, because that would sound pretty interesting, to say the least. All right, let's start recording here. Just give me a second here, guys. Just give me a second. All right. So let's get started here, drawing Groot and Rocket Raccoon. How fantastic. Right now, I'm just quickly calling up some reference here. And how awesome did Baby Groot look in the latest Guardians of the Galaxy trailer? Looked fantastic. So we're going to do a Baby Groot along with Rocket Raccoon. And Baby Groot, his outfit will probably be the one where he's wearing the big red leather jacket. Okay, so I have a couple images up here where he's wearing that little leather jacket. Okay. So I'm just gonna throw this quickly into Photoshop here, just so I can see. Okay, so just give me a second here. Oops. Okay, so you guys can't see, but I see. So, and I love how Baby Groot, like, he has this scream that he does, and he's really, really cute. Okay, so this is what we're gonna do. I'm gonna draw Baby Groot, okay, pretty much on this side here, okay? I'm gonna draw him on this side of the paper here, and then I'll draw like a smaller Rocket Raccoon in the back with a big honking gun, okay? So so I'm gonna start with Baby Groot, and he's gonna be pretty big, so I'm gonna start drawing here. We're gonna go make him really, really big here. So because he's closer to the ground, Rocket Raccoon, whoops. Rocket Raccoon is probably gonna be a lot smaller here, like this. Okay. So with that, sorry, just adjusting the lighting a tiny bit so we can see a little bit better. All right. So like we've done before, I'm gonna start pretty much working with my construction lines. The way I like to do it, I don't just draw a straight line here and a straight line across when I'm doing a face. I like to draw a line that goes all the way around the head, and that helps me fully understand and really start to think of all of these structures in 3D. I've talked a lot about that in my previous tutorials, how, you know, you should start really thinking in 3D. Here, think of things as round objects, 3D objects as opposed to 2D objects. That will really help your work here. Okay? So, now what makes a baby a baby? Okay? What makes a baby a baby is pretty much the size of the head, really. The size of the head. Now, babies pretty much have this gigantic head. And then the eyes, they say that eyes are the one thing that every human has that doesn't really grow. Okay, so when you're born, your eyes, they pretty much stay the same size while everything else kind of grows around it. So eyes naturally in babies are going to be big. They are going to be big. So that's kind of where we get that kind of manga-y feel when we are doing this. So I'm going to go ahead. And what I actually like to do is draw the entire eyeball. So I will actually go ahead and then draw this eyeball here and an eyeball here. Okay. See, I'm drawing the eyeball as it would be, like, inside the particular skull. Okay, so even though what's it called, Baby Groot, he is a tree. He is a tree. You know, I'm imagining that he has some sort of a tree skull inside here. Okay. Okay, and then you would have an open mouth here like this, yelling, ah, ah. Okay. Now from here, I'm gonna draw over top. I'm gonna draw over top a forehead. Okay, so again, all of these are construction lines. All of these are construction lines. I'm not going to be inking every single one of these lines. It's just something to help me fully understand how this head's going to work. Okay? And then I'm going to start drawing, okay, more like the eyelid. Okay? Even though, like, all of these are made out of bark, you will have an eyelid that goes around this round ball here. Okay? It's like a... It's like skin. Like, even though his face is bark, we are going to treat it like skin. We're going to treat it like skin, especially around the eyes. And if you look at eyes, they have all, you know, the way it folds, the way it kind of sticks, the skin sticks to the eyeball. All of that you have to kind of keep in mind whenever you're drawing something like this. Okay, so I'm going to go in here. Okay. And I'm going to... draw pretty much like eyelids here, as if he was like a flesh and blood type human. But then the way we're gonna render it is more bark like okay. And then what's gonna really, really turn this into a baby is the iris. It has to be big. It's gotta be big. Okay, and then we have teeth here. That doesn't look cute. But hopefully once I put the ink and then we erase some of these construction lines, it will definitely help. Okay, so. So now I'm roughing out a body here. Like, I didn't really work out a pose. So I'm gonna try to think of a nice little pose here for him. So the body's gonna be really, really small. Okay, so I'm just quickly putting up the reference of his actual costume here. Okay, so just in the head here, I'm gonna start adding some bark to the top of his head here. And again, for those of you who are asking, which I didn't mention before, I am using a Pilot Color Enoled. This is my main go-to pencil. I've been using this for almost 20 years now, this particular pencil. And the lead is here. This is the lead. This is the Pilot Color Enoled. Here, the one thing I like about this the most, and the reason I like to use this, is mainly because it erases really well, and it doesn't show up when I scan it, okay? There's lots of blue pencils on the market, lots of them, and this is just one I am completely comfortable in, all right? So, he doesn't look as cute as I want him to, so I'm gonna work on the cuteness factor of him. Work on the cuteness factor. So let me just throw in another lead here. Here we go. All right. Okay, so now once it's inked and then I add all the details. Like, right now it looks angry because it looks like he has these giant eye bags. But once I think all the details in, it will really, really help putting this out. Because right now it doesn't look as cute. I want him to look a little bit cuter than this. Just a little bit cuter. This is a reason why I wouldn't be very good doing anime characters. So even though this is simple, the actual head part, it's actually going to take a little bit longer because of all the detail I'm going to be putting into his mask. But in the meantime, let me just finish off this pose here. What I want to do with this pose. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead here. I'm going to go ahead and then let me just take a look at his costume quickly. Okay, so sorry, one second here. I might even make the body even smaller. So maybe we will do this in stages. I'm gonna actually, I really want to start inking this guy. I know they should say patience, but I really, really want to start inking. Inking Groot here because I'm having a lot of fun doing it right now, and I want to start seeing the cuteness come out a little bit. Okay, now, before we do anything, just to help my eyes, I'm bringing out the duck. I'm gonna go ahead and start erasing some of these around the eyes here, just to help me see if I need to correct anything here. Because sometimes with all these lines, things get lost a little bit. So I'm gonna spend most of my effort on these two eyes here, and then work with everything else. Okay, so I'm thinking actually the head might be a little too thick here. All right. Okay, so now pretty much the structure is pretty much almost done here. I'll keep the hands pretty simple for Groot. I'm just gonna keep them as kind of like these tree trunk type hands here. And I'll just have Rocket Raccoon here in the background, have him look all menacing with the gun. Okay, so I'm gonna treat this like two different pieces here. I'm gonna start with Groot, have him finish completely. Then I'm gonna go to Rocket Raccoon, have him finish completely. But now I'm gonna go ahead and start inking Rocket Raccoon. All right, so I'm gonna start it off with the micron. Pretty much I use microns. This is a Pigma micron. This is a 01. We're gonna start with a 01. And I use a variety of microns here. I got a 03, I got a 08, I got a 08, I got a 005, a 05. So a variety of microns. The only reason I use microns, in all honesty everyone, because it was on sale. That's the only reason I use them. So I'll use Prismacolors, I'll use Staedtlers, I'll even use the Copics, but I'll only use the cheapest one. But for me, they all work pretty much the same. That's why I do that, okay? So I'm gonna go ahead. Oh, okay guys, it stopped recording. Just give me one second here, guys. For all of you on the chat, I apologize. I haven't answered any questions yet. I will do it in one second here. Let me just get the intro to start inking, and then I will start answering some of your questions. So just give me a few more minutes, and then we will get going on that, okay? Just give me one second here. So right now, I'm going to start inking here with the 01. And this process I call, it's kind of like penciling with the ink pen. Now, if I were in comic books, I would probably use a pencil at this point. When I was in comic books, I would use a 2H Staedtler penciler, lead holder with a 2H lead. That's usually what I would use. And at this stage, that's where I would bring that into play. So if you want to use a pencil, this is where you would use it. Now, I like going in with the 01 because it's less work for me to do later on, because a lot of the fine lines are done, a lot of the decisions are done, and it's just a matter of thickening up the outlines. So I'm going to go ahead and start working these eyes, start really concentrating on the little folds that go around the eyes. And so I'm going to do that in time-lapse mode right now. And once that's done, then I will come back and we'll talk about it. All right, let's do that.
All right, guys.
I know some of you are patiently waiting for me to answer your questions. All right, guys. So sorry about that on the chat. For those of you who came a little bit later. I'm actually filming a tutorial at the same time, so that's why. 20,000, boy! 20,000, everyone! Woo! Woo! 20,000! Hooray! 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 Right on. my brother, the Z-Man's online here. Everyone say hi to the Z-Man. I want everyone to say hi to the Z-Man. if you guys don't know who the Z-Man is, he's the one who edits all my question and answer and all my interview videos. So thank you to my man, the Z-Man. Awesome guy. Whoop whoop, everyone. 20,000. Whoop whoop. All right. Okay, so I'm recording. All right. Okay, so just quickly, I saw one good question here. Mythbuster says, what does it mean that the teeth to the papers are different on Marvel versus DC? The paper textured or rougher, how does that change how you draw? Yes. When I was at DC Comics, they gave me the option. So you had a rougher style paper, so it did have a little bit more teeth, so it felt rougher to the touch. And then you had a completely smooth paper. Both take ink differently, but I liked a little bit of teeth. It helped hold some of the ink a little bit better, so that's why I liked that particular paper at that point. But both work well. To be honest, when I'm doing my Star Wars one, when I'm doing my Star Wars piece, all of that is on very, very smooth paper. Okay, so let's get watching here. Kane, I think you asked this before. Do you like Overwatch? I do like Overwatch, and fun fact. One of the head designers of that game, I used to work with him at a company called Dreamwave, long time ago. My friend Arnie, so proud of that guy. He is one of the main designers for Overwatch. All right, I believe he was, if not the co-art director, he's like the assistant or something like that. But all the promotional art you see, it's actually from him. He does all of it. He does all those promotional concept art. I can recognize his stuff from a mile away. That's him. That's all him, so... So yes, I do like Overwatch, absolutely here. Vinius, do you sell the drawings you show on the channel, or are they just your daily sketches? That's something I'm actually working on. I am looking at selling the drawings. I do sell my drawings, I do. If you see me at a convention, I usually have a portfolio out, and then I do sell my drawings. I'm actually working on starting a Facebook store, and that will have all the drawings that I do on here, on this channel, and then all the work I've done professionally. I don't have much emotional ties to my artwork. It's got to be something really, really special for me to keep it. There was only one piece of artwork I just couldn't bear parting with, and that was the Megalitho, the Transformers Megalitho. That's why I still have it. I actually put that on eBay. I put that on eBay years ago, and I had it on for a few days. I had quite the amount of offers for it. And in the end, I just couldn't part with it. So I stopped it. I ate the $50 or whatever it was, because I had like a $2,000, a $2,000 limit on it. Or minimum. So for that, you had to, you know, pay 50 bucks for that, for the minimum. And at the end, I couldn't bear parting with it. So I think I actually changed my mind. I actually would sell that now. So... Ulysses says, will I be collaborating with Jazza again? I'd love to collaborate again. We'll see. We have nothing planned right now, but we'll see what the new year holds. Okay. Let's see here. So I'm just going back, just seeing some of the questions you have here. Nonsense, thank you very much. I'm telling you, that's why I reached 20,000, was because of the 10-minute, 1-minute, 10-second challenge video. So I will be doing a ton more challenge videos. And in fact, I'm thinking about dedicating one of my streams to actually just doing challenge videos. One, because they're very short. I could probably bang one out, a really high-quality episode, in about half an hour, really. And not keep you guys too long. So I think that would be a little bit more palatable, and instead of trying to, you know, staying with me for like 3-4 hours, right? Trying to finish off a main drawing, which I'll still do because I know a lot of you like that too. But I'm really, really thinking about that. So in the new year, but thank you. But that's really why I was, my trajectory was not looking bright for me reaching 20,000 this year. And that video blew up. In my terms, it blew up. It's around what, 80,000 now? 80,000 views and that, so. Jake says, have you ever drawn something for the companies and have they used it in advertising? Jake, I've worked in comic books before. I worked about 6 years in comic books. In terms of advertising, like I've done box art for Transformers. So I've done for Transformers Armada way back in the day. Like way, 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 way back in the day. So yeah, that would be, yes. So the answer is yes. The answer is yes. So, do I play Pokemon Go? No. Like I mentioned before, I try to avoid all video games. I would desperately want to play, but I just don't have the time to play. So, it's better to stop before I get addicted. Because I know I would get addicted to playing that thing. And, I don't want to. Joaquin asked if I've seen Road 1. I actually answered that earlier, but don't mind answering again. I'm going to see it tomorrow night. I have my tickets. It's for 10:40 p.m. Eastern tomorrow. So that's when I'm going to see it, mainly because if I don't see it at that time, I'm never going to be able to go on the internet. So, and I cannot wait. So hopefully I can have some vloggers. So, Sado asks, what kind of blend the blue one you use for outlines? Again, that's Eno colored, I keep forgetting the name. Color Eno LED from Pilot. Okay. Do I like Arkham Knight? I like the designs. I love the designs of Arkham Knight. So again, like I don't play these games, but I'll go and I'll buy the art books or look at the art books, and then I will go from there. But I try to avoid playing games just because I know how addicting they get, and I know how easy it is for me to get distracted. So that's why I try to avoid playing games at all costs. So, yeah. Thank you. Thank you for those who like the background music. Awesome. Awesome. So just looking back here, a lot of questions here. Let's see here. Vinicius, no problem. Set up a website. Yeah, well, I'm trying to keep it as low maintenance as possible. And I think I'm actually going to get someone to help me run the site so I can concentrate on other things, you know, because, you know, even doing my thing like shipping and packing and all that stuff, like I don't have a lot of time for that stuff. So I'm trying to find the most time-efficient way to do all these things. That's why I kind of like the idea of the Facebook store. It makes things a little bit easier than setting up a website for all this stuff. So that's why. Would I sell any of the Star Wars pieces one day? What's the name? My friend Jonathan asked me that. Yes, but it's not going to be cheap. And I'm only selling them together. Now, if this were to become official, if this actual project becomes official, and there's actually a high probability it might be able to become official, then Lucasfilm actually has first right refusal for all artwork that's done. So they have the right to buy it first, before anyone else. That's actually a contract that I signed long time ago when I did Star Wars Tales for Dark Horse, long time ago. Everyone had to sign that if you wanted to work on the Lucasfilm artwork. So if they want to buy it, they have the right to buy it first. Now, like right now, nothing's happened yet. So that's if it ever becomes official, then they were the first right of refusal. But I would only sell everything at once. So it's got to be the hardest of the hardcore Star Wars fan who's probably going to be able to buy this thing, and they got to have a lot of money. Because it's going to take a lot of money for me to part with that thing. So, do I know Horizon Zero Dawn robots? I actually haven't heard of those. So, what should I draw today? Thank you very much. Right on. What should I draw today? By the way, what should I draw today? I did send your prize finally on Friday. So they did tell me it should get there before the end of the year, I'm hoping, right? So, will I draw the new Spider-Man from Homecoming? Possibly. Mythbusters like the rough drawing around the eyes at the beginning. Thank you very much. Thank you. So I'm going ahead here and I'm actually trying to draw in the eyes a little bit more. Okay. Thank you for liking the suit, by the way. Thank you. Ulysses has been keeping you up for a while now. Thanks a lot. Do you know smoke detectors to like the lock of oxygen room? That's true. Let's see here. Who's your favorite Overwatch character from Kane? I'll say Winston. I like Winston. He's pretty cool. Alright. Thank you, Martin. Thank you very much. No, Brian. Here's the thing with Jazza, okay? Jazza, my good friend. And be careful. He likes to pop in on my streams. Be careful what you say, guys. But my buddy Jazza, that guy is a performer. That guy. Here's the thing about Jazza, guys. And, you know, if he hears this or not, like, I don't care. He's pretty much what I want. I've always dreamed I wanted to be at that age. At that age. He's, what, 25 right now? 25, with a gigantic YouTube following, doing art the way he wants to do art. Like, that's the dream, guys. That's the dream. That's what I wanted to do back in those days, doing art on his terms, right? Like, and the guy can play the drums. He's such a performer, does theater. Like, oh, man. That's, you know, that's how I always wanted to do my life around that time, Good looking dude, too, at the same time, right? So, so that's why I actually look up to him, even though I'm way older than him. That's why I look up to him, for sure. Helen asks, do I still read a lot of comic books? Not as much anymore. Same reason why I don't play video games as much anymore. That's why I do bring my son to the comic book store from time to time. A lot of good Groupon deals on comics now, too. But I honestly have not bought a comic book in quite a while, in all honesty. So, okay. Okay, so. Okay, this turned off. Let me just go quickly here. There's a lot of questions here. So, guys, I won't be able to answer all of these questions. So, let me just see here if I could answer a few of them here. Yes, I'm in Canada. Whoever asked where I was in Canada. I'm in Toronto, Canada. Oh, my buddy Albert's on here. How you doing, Albert? I still got my Transformer Armada comic, July 20, 2002. And fun fact, guys, when I went back to school in 2007, I found a lot of my Transformer Armadas number one all in the quarter bin. They were all in the quarter bin. And now I'm kicking myself because I should have picked them all up. I should have bought all of them. Have I seen The Art of the Last of Us? I browsed through that at the store, and it is amazing. That's one I might pick up over the holidays if I can find a nice sale on it. Martin asks, what's the salary of a comic book artist? I actually have a video where I run through that exact question. It's a 20-minute video where I run through exactly how a comic book artist makes money. So check that out on my channel, okay? So it's called How Much Does a Comic Book Artist Actually Make? Okay, so you could check that out. And I outline all the different avenues that a comic book artist uses to make a living. Okay? Okay. Do I like the show Corner Gas? That was a funny show. I was always a fan of Brett Butt. That in his name, Brett Butt. Brett Butt. But yeah, Corner Gas is a funny show. Funny show. Purely Canadian, too. You know, the Canadian shows always have that Canadian flavor to them. Those CBC shows. So. Oh, thank you, Jason. I appreciate that. Yeah, check him out. They're a lot of fun. They're a lot of fun. We can all laugh at the artwork nowadays. Like, it's not the best. It's not the best. So, oh boy. Game Worthy wants me to say his name. That's your name, Game Worthy. All right. How do I start a career as a comic book artist? Emilio asks. Check out my series on how to become a comic book artist. It's a 7-part comic book series where I run through the way I would try to break into comics today. And then also check out John Barber's podcast. My interview with John Barber. He's a Marvel editor, and we work together at IDW. And he gives some great advice on how to break in and what editors look for. So check out those two. I highly recommend those on my channel. Okay, so okay, I'm gonna go back to filming in a second here, but let me just go quickly here. Indiana Jones or Han Solo? I'm going Han Solo. Let's see here. You rock. Thank you very much. Okay, guys, I wish I could answer all your questions. You have some great questions here. I just can't answer all of them. Let me just go back to Film City really quickly, and we will go there. Thank you for the nice suit. The winner of the 20,000 subscriber piece, I have not chosen a winner yet. The winner will be announced in the time-lapse version of this piece here, okay? So if you check out the time-lapse version, that should be up, probably, I'm hoping tomorrow. We'll see. So probably tomorrow. That's when I will announce it, so not tonight. Okay. All right. So okay, guys. So just give me a second here. Oh, just here. Tarini Wag says, "Do you keep a sketchbook?" The answer is no. Mainly because I draw so much as it is. I draw so much as it is, and I just don't. I won't say I don't have time, but all the drawing I'm doing right now takes up all my time. It's all finished drawings right now, so that's probably why. So, okay, bye, Julia. Thanks for joining in. Okay, guys, I'm just gonna say something quickly about the eyes, and then I'll get back to your questions. Okay, so one second here. Okay, so I went ahead and I inked the eyes. So things to think about when you're inking eyes: highlights really, really, really make the eyes. Eyes have to have kind of these wet feel, no matter what kind of character it is. It could be like an alien, could be a character made out of wood, all of that. But what really kind of humanizes characters is when we get to the eyes. So that's why you have to have a lot of reflection when it comes to the eyes. Now, when you're doing it in black and white, the best way to do that is to have like little spots, kind of like this here, and that kind of helps bring out kind of that wetness in the eyes. Now, one thing I might want to add to these things, whoops, is like little veins here. And sometimes this would be better in color. If I were to add the veins in the color, it would be better. But since for the most part, this will be a black and white drawing. Then we can add the veins like that. So right now, I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna draw in the mouth. And then I'm gonna start laying in some of the texture on his face, which actually will be the fun part, is doing the texture on the face. So let's do that right now. Okay, guys, back to the things. Okay, Orlando says, "Who's my favorite comic book artist today? Today and for always, Jim Lee's the man. He's my hero. If you guys want a good success story, check out Jim Lee's podcast with Kevin Smith. I've said this before in my streams. If you haven't already, check that podcast out. That will help inspire you if you're trying to get into comic books itself. That's one of the best ones. Because that was really inspiring to me. Just for me, though. I'm not looking to get into comics anymore, though, so that's not my jam. But if you guys are looking to try to work for Marvel DC, that's a great podcast to listen to. I would love to interview Jim Lee one of these days, but the only way I could get to these guys is if, you know, if I meet him at conventions and stuff. So, how often do you color your work? Who asked that? So seal mode. I'm trying to do my best to make sure I mention you guys. How do I color my work? I color with Photoshop, and if you're asking how often, not often recently, mainly because of time. Again, it's all because of time. I have so many things on the go right now. So, pretty much all the drawing I'm doing right now really is for my streams. Yeah, all the drawing I'm doing is for my stream, so that's why I don't really color it. Now, I will be coloring the entire Star Wars piece. I will be coloring that whole thing. So you can look out for that. I'm going to be time-lapsing that whole thing, so you guys can check that out. All right. Okay, hold on. Every time I scroll, it goes down to the bottom. I apologize that. Vinchnu wants a shout out. There's your shout out. There you go. Would I consider creating a Patreon? Not yet in terms of Patreon. And I'll tell you why. I have nothing against Patreon. Nothing at all. I think it's actually great. It's nice to support. However, for me, it'd be hard to keep up with the rewards. And if I'm going to do that, if I'm going to do Patreon, if someone's going to pay me money, I want to give them a reason to give me money. Right? So whether, you know, whatever rewards that you buy, I want to make sure they're the highest quality, and I just don't have the time to do something like that. Like, I have a buddy, he works at, again, he worked with me at Dreamwave. He actually works on League of Legends. He's one of the illustrators for League of Legends. He works on at Riot Games, and he started his Patreon, and it just takes a lot of time. It takes a lot of time. So if I ever do a Patreon, I just want to make sure that, the rewards, like, I wouldn't do it without any rewards. There's no way I would let you guys give me money without getting anything in return. So I have to make sure the rewards would be worth it for you guys. I don't want to, you know, make it, you know, what's it called? Be stingy on the rewards type thing. So that's why. Let's see here. Do I look like cookies? Love cookies. I love cookies. All right, let me go up here. I think there was more questions in the chat here. Let's see here. Do you think you can release an ebook with your line art? I would love to see your art collected together. I've been thinking about that, but I'm still kind of, I'm not sure the legalities around that, because again, all my stuff is like fan art, right? So I don't know. Now, I got buddies, Transformers artists, they have sketchbooks, but they get permission from Hasbro, right? So Hasbro gives them the permission to do that and sell it, right? Because they know they're not making like gangbusters on them. So they're okay with that. So maybe if I ask Hasbro, maybe I could do something like that. But it would just be Transformers artwork. It wouldn't be any of the other stuff. Right? So it's one of those type of things. I'm not sure. So who asked that? PJ maybe asked that. Thank you very much, PJ. All right. TF Hero, so was it my comment that gave you the idea to draw Baby Groot? Possibly. I don't remember, but possibly. Let's see here. Okay. Do I use Copics? Jans asked. No, that's one of the things I'm actually going to be doing on my channel next year, is me trying to figure out what these Copics are, things are. Now, back in the day, I used to use Tria markers. Back in the day. That's what we used to use. Copics weren't around yet back this time. So I'm talking about 1999, 2000. So we would use Prismacolor markers. So those were considered the high-end back then. Prismacolor markers and the Tria markers. So I would have a whole bunch of Tria markers back in the day. But now Copics are the thing, and they're just so expensive. I was highly considering coloring the Star Wars piece with Copic markers first, but because of my lack of skill and my lack of confidence, I said, you know what, it'd be better, I'll just computer color the whole thing. Though, if I did do the Copic marker for that thing, I bet you any of that piece would shoot up in value, like double at least, if I colored that thing. But considering the time I have, probably not. So, okay. We go back down. Thank you guys for joining in tonight. Really appreciate it. Okay, here. Pen or pencil? Pen. All right, Ariel says it wants this. Ariel wants me to pronounce your name, or Ariel. So Ariel, welcome. What I could, okay, we talked about Patreon already. That's great. Mark asks about working for the big two and portfolio. Again, check out all my artist series, but I say check out the John Barber one. That one probably has the best advice when it comes to what to put in the portfolio and all that kind of stuff. So check that one out. Just because it was that's a long question. So where did I learn drawing from? Practice. Galaxy Twilight asked me that. Have I read Jazz's new book of creating characters? Kane asks. You know what? I actually went to order that book a couple days ago, and my Indigo doesn't carry it anymore. Like it had it on pre-order. It was my fault for not pre-ordering it. I should have pre-ordered it, and now I can't get it. So I'll probably have to buy it off Amazon or something now. But I really wanted to get it. And all my son, I showed the previews to my son. He really liked it. So I wanted to get it for my son, really. Also, honestly, it was more for me. Oh, boy. Okay, so. All right. It's one thing you don't like drawing. Film artist asks, one thing you don't like drawing? I don't like drawing water, especially in ink. I don't like drawing. This is gonna sound weird. I don't like drawing the same thing twice. Does that make sense? That's one thing. That's the real reason I don't want to draw comics again, because I love drawing single illustrations. But if I have to draw the same thing over and over and over again, that's when it gets tedious for me, right? That's where you lose the fun, especially if you draw something as complicated as Transformers. I love drawing Transformers. I love it. I absolutely love it. But at the same time, it gets so tedious. That's why I really burnt myself out when I did Dark Cybertron a few years ago. Was it 2013? I did Dark Cybertron for them. I burnt myself out because I forgot the grind and everything I wanted to do detail-wise. It really burnt me out. So one of the reasons why I went back into film for a little bit after that, I wouldn't say that's the main reason. The main reason was because my good friend, he really needed me to come back. He needed help. So I went back to help him. Okay. So. Let's see here. Just looking at the questions here. Quickly, do I look cookies? I think you asked that before, right? Oh, I think I answered that already. Let's see here. The little pacey asks, can you draw Daredevil soon? I did do a Daredevil picture in my recently, a few months ago. So check that out. And also check out Charlie Cox's reaction to that drawing when you're done, okay? Actually, just watch the reaction. If you guys haven't seen John Barenthal and Charlie Cox reacting to my artwork, go check that out on my channel. If you're new here and haven't seen that video, that is one of my favorite videos of all time. Check that out, and you'll also see the drawing I did of the Punisher and Daredevil for that. So check that out, all right? Miss Dutsters, thank you very much. Appreciate that. So I'm going to draw a tongue in here, and it will be a tongue that's kind of like, again, what makes Groot is this feeling of bark, right? So what Star Wars movie is your favorite, excluding Force Awakens? That's a good question. Let's say, like, I think everyone says Empire. I would say, for me, it's a toss-up. I love Empire. I also love A New Hope as well, so I'm kind of torn between the two, which one I would pick over the other. If you give me push comes to shove, if I had to, like, I can't watch the other one forever, I would probably pick A New Hope. I would, mainly because it's the original. As awesome as Empire is, I would probably pick A New Hope over it. But that's a tough question, right? So, but I know a lot of people would pick Empire over A New Hope also, right? So it's one of those type of deals. So Dreadnought, thank you very much. Appreciate that. Where do I see myself 10 years from now? I'm not sure. I'm not sure. I'm going to be old. Because I'll be in my late 40s by that time. So I'm hoping it's either going to go two ways. Either I'm going to be this guy selling my properties, creating new properties, or I'm going to be an art director somewhere. Those are the two paths here. So I'm either going to be an art director or a guy creating properties. So either or. Okay, so. All right. Do I stream every day? Not really. Probably twice a week. I will do it twice a week for sure. Okay, official Rogue Nine, welcome, very welcome. I keep saying welcome very much. Does that make sense? Welcome very much. Michael Self says, I hold my son. I won't reveal that. I try not to reveal too much about my kids. So forgive me, I'm not going to reveal that. All right. Let me see here. What about Return of the Jedi? I like Return of the Jedi. Ewoks speak Tagalog. I actually really like Return of the Jedi. I've watched it the past week. I've watched that at least four times now the past week. And I really like it. Let's see here. How do you talk and draw simultaneously? Very slowly, apparently. Vishma asked more about concept artists. I'll tell you what, Vishma. I do teach concept art at my school, Max the Mutt. However, if you really, really want to learn the ins and outs of concept artists, go check out Feng Zhu right now. You gotta check out all his artwork. He's got 100 videos online. He has a school in Singapore, I believe. But check out, and his podcast. At the very least, check out his podcast, Feng Zhu, F-E-N-G-Z-H-U. Everything you want to learn about being a concept artist, you can learn way better from him than you can from me. So, let you know that right now, okay? All right. So, I'm going to keep recording here. Z-H-U. Z-H-U. Feng Zhu. He is the man. He's worked on... I think he worked on episode 3, actually, Star Wars. He worked on so many things. He worked on Transformers. He's the real deal. Okay, Feng Zhu's the man. Okay, so just give me a second here, guys. I'm just going to do a quick thing for the tutorial. Okay. So as you can see here, I started adding in all of these lines here. Pretty much I'm trying to mimic bark when I am coming in here. So I'm trying to find a fine line between, you know, like minimalist and detail here. I don't want to get too much into it, but I do want that feel of wood when it comes to his skin. Now, right now, I'm just using my Dura marker here, or using a fat Sharpie, and I'm just going to outline this. I like putting a thick outline around, and that helps. That helps kind of pop out all these things. Okay, so I'm gonna finish the outline, and then I'm gonna go back in and add a little bit more detail to the face, and then I'm gonna go ahead and start detailing up the body. Okay, let's do that. One second here, guys. So let me go back here. Who's your favorite Jedi Knight? Kit Fisto. Let's go with Kit Fisto. Okay. Hey, who's your favorite? Slunchbox asks, who's your favorite artist? Let's go non-traditional here. Now, like a lot of my earlier followers, they know. Was it the Big Five now? It's the Big Five. Jim Lee, Stephen Platt, David Finch, what's it called? Travis Charest, and Jeff Darrow. Those were my Big Five. If you ask other artists that influenced me, let's go Alex Ross. Alex Ross really influenced me. Brian Hitch. If you guys don't know Brian Hitch, he is the man. I was trying to draw like him for a long time. Let's see here. I said Alex Ross already. Norman Rockwell. How about we go really painterly? Norman Rockwell. Love his stuff. Caravaggio. When I was in school, that's one of the artists I really studied. And if you look at Caravaggio's stuff, you could really see some of that influence. He's very, very dark. Very, very dark. So, you could tell that's a huge influence. There. So, there's some for you, okay? Now, Empire did scare me because Luke lost his skin, right? Thank you very much, Vinius. What's the difference between open inking and marker inking? Or G-Pen? What's a G-Pen? Can you let me know? I'm not sure what that is. Do you leave little things in your artwork? Are you talking about like Easter eggs, right? Are you talking about, oh, yeah. If you're talking about Easter eggs, it depends. Sometimes I'll do things like put names of my kids and all that stuff. I used to do that. Not so much recently. Usually when someone does something like that, it's usually because they're bored out of their mind. They just want to try to do something that could kind of keep themselves interested more in the work. So, right on. Okay, so. Mythbuster Zuo wants me to leave it like this. Yes, but then I wouldn't be me. So. Okay, Mythbuster wants me to get to the costume. Just give me a second here. Give me a second. All right. Who's my favorite character from Guardians of the Galaxy? As much as I love all of them, gotta be Drax. Number one, because I'm a huge wrestling fan too. So I was always a fan of Bautista. Dave Bautista. And second, he's part Filipino, right? And third, he's just funny. Dude was just funny. I think I mentioned this before. I've never laughed out loud as hard as when I saw that latest Guardians of the Galaxy trailer. Never laughed as hard when I saw that Drax part at the end. Oh, man, I was rolling. It's hitting the table, you know? You know that kind of laugh? Those big belly laughs, like, ah! You hit the table and all that kind of stuff. That's the kind of laugh I had when I saw that trailer. So, right now, when I'm making this, I'm really keeping in mind where the lighting's coming from here. I always talk about that. I think I'm just getting a light that's coming out like this. But just to make sure that everything's consistent. It's more of a consistency thing, guys. Once you figure out where your lighting is, keep it that way. And that will help your drawings so much if your lighting is consistent. Okay? If you know lighting's coming this way, make sure it's that way for all of it, all of your drawings there. So. Let me see here. All right, let's just go back here. Let's see here. A G-Pen is used by manga artists, so I've never actually worked on it. What's my opinion on Alex Maleev? He's a fantastic storyteller. So like that. I hope you don't laugh like that in real life. Well, that's too bad. I hope you guys don't think I'm putting on an act for you, because this is me. This is, if you talk to me every day, this is how I'm going to talk to you. So. Tarini, thank you very much. Thank you. All right. Starting to look older and angrier. I think you're right, Mythbuster. Maybe I'm starting to go too much with it. That's the problem with going a little bit of detail, and Mythbuster is right. If you add too much detail, then he starts looking older. That's what happens here. So thank you for pointing that out. I'm actually going to stop adding some things here. I'm just going to add like a few things on the top here. Solid point there. Thank you very much. Thank you for the show, Rogue Nine. I'm sure you will. Just practice. You're going to be better than me. Don't worry. Thank you, PJ. I appreciate that. Thank you. Right on. And again, guys, I don't mind critiques at all when it comes to word work. Honestly, it's been beaten into me, critiques, for the longest time. So trust me, you work in film, you got to get used to critiques. But the only time I have a problem with it is when people do name calling. I had that a lot when people call you, you know, all these names. I won't get into the names they were calling me. Like, I don't mind. Like, is there something wrong with my artwork? No problem. Tell me so I can get better. I want to get better, too. But when you start calling me names, then things get, you know what I mean? Be respectful. That's all. So, let's see here. let's see. When you say you tried playing any games, what was the last game I played? Oh, I'm trying to think. I don't even remember. Altered Beast? Who here remembers Altered Beast? Come on. Come on. Come on. Who here remembers Altered Beast? Come on. One to ten. How much I like poutine? That's an 11, my friend. Poutine! Who doesn't like a good poutine? Though, I need to start my diet, guys. That's why I got sick. That's why I got sick. So I gotta start my diet. My wife didn't come down with the cake. I wanted a piece of cake. Yeah. Mark remembers. That's right. Oh, boy. You know, I think they're actually going to make a movie of Altered Beast. So, for those of you who don't know, Altered Beast is a Sega game. It's a Sega game. I used to have a Sega Master System back in the day. My mom wouldn't let me play video games that much when I was a kid. She would say, hey, that's gambling. Back when we would have arcades back then, kids. Back in arcades. Are there arcades around now? Oh, yeah, Mythbusters is right. Cell phone or Facebook game? Probably. Not a Facebook game. Probably, let's say, Candy Crush. Okay. Oh, no. You know which game I played? I have on my phone? You guys are going to hate me for this. Watch this, guys. Watch this. Hold on. You guys are going to hate me for this. Watch this. I'll show you. Where is it? There you go. Look at this. Oh, you're going to hate me for this, guys. Listen. Any of you guys have this game? Wait, hold on. Not that game. Wait, hold on. I pressed the... Any of you have this game? Oh, I lost. One more time. Okay, that's enough. Okay, how many viewers did I lose from that? Okay. Okay, it stopped, guys. Come back. Alright, come back. Oh, boy. All right, guys, I'm going back to the drawing. Oh, boy. Okay, so now I'm going to go ahead and start drawing the body here, guys. Okay? I know a lot of you have been waiting for the body. Before that, how about cheers to you guys? Cheers. How about Swig? Cheers to you. I gotta finish this now because, you know, I'm still a little bit sick, so I can't save it for later because it might make me sick. So I gotta finish it tonight. All right, here we go. Okay, so I'm gonna film just a tiny bit of an intro for my for the tutorial part, guys, and then I will go back to the chat. Just give me a second. Okay, so now I'm okay with the head, and as some of my viewers popped out, maybe I went a little bit too overboard with some of the lines, so he's starting to look a little bit older. One thing, when you add more lines to somebody, the same thing applies to when it's women as well. The more lines you apply, the older they get. Now, for when you're drawing males, for some reason, that doesn't apply as much. But I find when you do add too many lines, then you start looking a little bit older, especially for things like kids and women. Okay, so maybe I went a little bit too far, but I'm kind of liking the way it's going right now, so maybe some color would help this out. But in the meantime, I'm going to start going ahead and draw the body part. So I'm going to go ahead again with the one and start outlining all the details first before I go in with the black. So let's do that. Okay, guys, looking at the time right now, I'm already way over the time I thought I would do for this. So just to let you guys know, I'm going to go as long as it takes to get this done. So please, you know, stay on as long as you would like. Come and chat. I'd love to chat with you guys. So please stay on. I'll lose my voice. I'll lose my voice to talk to you guys. So please stay on. Be great. All right. So yeah. Who are some of your favorite comic book artists? And it's great to see that. Todd Knock. There's a guy I want to collab with. Todd Knock. That guy's pretty awesome. He's great, and he's a really fast artist too. That's one thing I always admired about Todd Knock, how fast he was. Like, that guy could do 2 books a month easily. And again, it's pretty much because of the style, right? So let me just see here. I'm recording. All right. Let me just make sure I have the right, even before I record there, let me just make sure I have the right reference for Groot here. What's my favorite color on a lightsaber? Let's say white. I got burp, guys. Whoa, excuse me. That's a 20,000 subscriber burp right there. I think I just need screenshots of the trailer here. Maybe I'll just pull up the trailer. Just quickly download the trailer. Maybe I'll do that. So it'll be a little easier. Julian says, should I watch or do my essay? Do your essay. You can always come back and watch this later. No problem. All right. Yeah. So honestly, if you guys, if you're drawing at the same time, this is the best time to draw for sure. So let me just download quickly the trailer here. So Guardians, just so I could get, I really need to get the Baby Groot thing right. So let's see here. What do I think of Joe Quesada's work on the covers of Marvel Knights Daredevil? I loved his stuff. I really, really do. He was one of my bigger inspirations, Joe Quesada too. Mainly, not necessarily because of the style, but more of the dynamic poses he would do. All his poses have so much energy and life to them. That's one thing I really, really loved about his work. So that's pretty much why I love his stuff. So hold on, guys, I'm just trying to find the trailer here. Have I ever messed up a piece that I made because of food? Tyranny asks. I think I have. I just don't remember if I did or not. I'm pretty sure I have. I think I did it on a Marvel book too, if I'm not mistaken. So I wonder why my let's see here. TF Arrow, you're funny. Hold on, I'm just looking for Root's jacket here. haven't seen yet. Yeah, you don't really even see it that well in the trailer, too. So, Brandon says, what art app for Android would you prefer using? Jazza's app. Jazza's Arty Games app. Okay? Let me do the plug quickly. I'm not getting any money from this, but if you guys have not seen Jazza's Arty Games app, get it, because it's a lot of fun. I'm going to actually be playing more games, probably live with it, just because it's a lot of fun doing it. So, check out my Arty Games. I've done a couple on my channel. Check them out if you get the chance. Where is it? Ah, here it is. It's boosted my Arty Games. But yeah. So, not another app. Get Pokemon Go. No! There we go. You guys know I have this. I have to have this. So I'll play this, guys. You know which game I want to play, guys? You know which game I want to play for you guys, which I think will be fun? It'll be the Copy Challenge. Copy Challenge looks like fun. Because you get the Copy Challenge. What happens with the Copy Challenge? You go here. I'll probably do this on the stream. So they'll have a picture, and I got to copy it. Like, for example, there's a dog. And I have to draw that same thing. But I won't do it for 10 minutes. Maybe I'll do like a minute. I'll try to recreate it in a minute, that type of thing. So, that kind of thing. Maybe I'll try to do something like that. Next time. Raven, I did not finish the Falcon, unfortunately. I'll probably finish that on Facebook tomorrow. So I'll probably stream that on Facebook tomorrow. But let me get to finally drawing here. Okay, I've been wasting a lot of time. You guys know I love talking to you. I'm talking to you guys, so let me go back here. One title. So I'm probably gonna get part of his costume wrong because I don't see a lot of it. So he has like a little collar here, and then he has another collar that goes like this. Okay, and now I'm gonna draw sockets for his arms. Okay, and then it looks like he's got a lot of the way it's done here, a lot of folds. But you know the best way when you don't know how a costume should look, guys? The best way is to cover it with black. So I think that's what I'm going to do. When I'm not sure the costume, but in doubt, cover it with black. So he's going to have a lot of folds. It looks like even as small as this costume is, it's still a little big on him. So I'm going to draw the folds in here like this. Now folds, guys, if you want to learn how to draw folds, it's one of the bigger, you know, things to learn is how to get folds to look right. You can't go wrong with life. You cannot go wrong with life. So especially if you're starting out, you want to draw folds, get yourself a jacket or something, and then, you know, try to put it in the proper position, and then try to draw the folds and try to understand how the material wraps around and all that fun stuff. And that will help you. See, as you can see, my lines are very sketchy. Whenever I do something like this, it's just very, very sketchy. So, which is fine because I'm going to clean it up with black anyway. So, let's see. Mooch is here. Hi, Mooch. How you doing, my dear? Good to see you. Liam wants me to notice her. Him. Liam, a drama. I notice you. Do I have tips when copying people's faces? You have more than one picture of his face. Okay, so if you're trying to draw a celebrity, for example, get multiple angles of that person's face, and then really try to understand how his face works in 3D. How his face works in 3D, that will help you out so much. You know, okay, instead of just saying the line here, that's like 2 inches from the line here, that type of thing. That's always tougher way to do it. Try to understand the way the face would actually work in 3D. That will help you out a lot. So, thank you, Mooch. Thank you. You're the best. Oh, by the way, my friend Mooch is here. She is matte painting supervisor at Pixelmundo. She's working on a ton of gigantic movies right now. Go check out her website, Mujia.com. Mujia.com. I'm actually going to write in the chat here. Go check out her stuff. She's amazing. Mujia.com. Okay, check her out, all right? Her workout, okay? Be civil, guys. Too late, Mooch. All right. My friend Mooch. That's what you get for coming on the stream. But her work is amazing. Check out her work, okay? All right. All right. Let's see. Mooch does deserve all the praise. She taught me everything I know about matte painting. So check out Mooch. She's awesome, all right? Cool. Okay, so now I'm going to go with black. Okay, guys, just give me a second here. I'm going to, again, film a part for the tutorial. So just give me a second here, guys, all right? Oop, I took a picture. All right, so I sketched out the arms and the body here. Now, we're in a situation here where I don't really... because there's not much reference out there for the way his costume looks, so I'm gonna cover a lot of this in black just to kind of hide it. Okay, so we'll see here. But as you can tell here, I just wanted to draw in some of the folds. Now, I mentioned to the people who are watching me live, the best way to draw folds, guys, is to actually look at folds. So go check out, you know, get yourself a shirt or a jacket, you know, bend the arms, and just really try to study how material works around arms. So if you can see my arm here. How the material here, you see, if I pull it like this, why does it pull this way? Why is there a flap here? Stuff like that. And really study how it kind of wraps around arms, how gravity affects the folds of the costume. So check that out. So that's what I've done here. Now I'm going to go in and add some black to this kind of to finish this off. All right. Right. Since Mooch is here, guys, let's cheers to her. My Diet Coke. Mooch loves Diet Coke, by the way. Cheers. You like my Diet Coke, Mooch? Woo! Alright. Now. Oh, that hurt. Oh, guys. Oh, I gotta... Oh, I'm gonna die on the live stream. Careful. Excuse me. All right. You know, Mooch. Mooch just said I sing amazing. I put me singing on my channel, and I lost 50 subscribers right away. So trust me, they don't want to hear me singing. Sing, sing, sing. Now they want to hear us sing. Well, I can't sing. I got background music here. Maybe a little bit later. Actually, I'm not lying, Mooch. If you guys haven't seen it yet, on my second channel, I do this duet with Jazza. Or you know how Jazza likes to sing on his vlog channel? And what I did was I took that, and then I recorded me doing some harmonizing parts to Jazza. So it was like a duet with me and Jazza. So if you guys haven't seen that, you can actually see that on my vlog channel. Maybe I can actually put a link to that. And you can see me sing there, okay? Maybe when I'm closer to the end, I'll sing for you guys, all right? I'll sing for you guys. You can tell me what to sing if you guys want me to sing, all right? And besides, I'm sick. My voice won't go high. But here, let me check if I can find quickly. Oops, let me just turn this main camera off. Let me see if I can find quickly that one with me and Jazza. You guys can check that out on your own time. Here. Oh, Mooch. Oh, you. let's see. Okay, hold on. Let me just check my vlog here. second here. I'll find the link here, guys. You can check it out yourself so you'll stop bothering me. 1 second here, guys. okay. Because as you guys know, Jazza is an amazing singer. Like, he's like a Broadway singer, right? So, he was singing this Journey song. I wanted to sing with him. So, I found it. Hold on. Okay. Do a Musical.ly. I do have a Musical.ly. Liam Drama, if you check it, I do have a Musical.ly. Go check out Box Office Artists on Musical.ly. I got it. All right. Liam Drama, I just gave you one, okay? Okay, in the chat right now, guys, in the chat, go check that link out there. That is me singing with Jazza. Go check it out, all right? Drop my beats. you guys are awesome. Drop my mixtape. No, Jazza is an amazing, amazing singer. You gotta see him, because that's how he met his wife. He met him, I think he was doing Joseph and the Technicolor Dreamcoat, if I'm not mistaken, right? So Jazza is exactly what I want to be at his age. So that's it. Liam Drama, I gave you so many shout outs already. Liam Drama Goldfish, go check him out, or her out, by the way. Bye, what should I draw today? Let me know if that thing finally comes in the mail, okay? All right, here we go. I'm gonna go back and start really darkening up Baby Groot here. Have some fun. Okay, fast food of choice. Hold on a second here, guys. I'm just pulling over so I can see what I'm actually showing you guys. There. Fast food of choice, KFC. Oh, no, not KFC, Popeyes. I love the Popeyes. Who wants a shout out? Moza Bros wants a shout out. Moza Bros, shout out. Who else wants a shout out? Shout outs for everyone. You get a shout out. You get a shout out. Everyone gets a shout out. Shout out for everyone. Shout out. See, guys, best way to hide that you don't know what the costume is supposed to look like. A lot of black. Okay. All right. They have a drama. How many times are you going to ask for a shout out? Okay. Game Worthy wants a shout out. Shadows, was it? Sky Shadow wants a shout out. Joe Biden wants a shout out. All right. Okay, What's the best death in Star Wars? Han Solo was pretty predictable. Han Solo was pretty predictable. Obi-Wan was a good... Well, yeah, he was a good one, but he was the only one who actually... Well, he was the first one to disappear, and then I was listening to a lot of podcasts of why he disappeared, as opposed to dying the way Qui-Gon did. Because Yoda also disappeared, right? So, hey, I got a message. Did someone of you guys email me? Oh, did Mooj go? Okay, bye, Mooj. Thanks for joining in. You're the best. If you guys ever go to Fan Expo, you can meet Mooj. She has a table there. She always has a table there. Or even at Anime North. For a lot of the anime cons, she's usually there, so you guys can check her out. There's a lot of amazing fan art. Game of Thrones art too. If you guys like Game of Thrones, check that out. Check that stuff out. Alright. Liam Drama Goldfish, I gave you like 10 shoutouts already. Okay. Bye, take care, buddy. Alright. How long does it take you to do a 5-page comic? Depends on how much detail I want to put into it. For the most part, in the comic industry, you only have, for that, they usually give you 5 days. So, page a day. Page a day keeps the editor away, as we would say. Back in the day. No way, Jose. Okay. So you see here the knee? You see that the knee? So I'm trying to make it look like his knee's in front, but his jacket covers part of his leg. So that's why I'm going to do it like this. And then let the imagination fill in the rest of him. You see that? Black. All right. Ariel wants me to sing Let It Go. Careful what you wish for. Okay, at the end of the stream. How about that? I'm going to sing Let It Go at the end of the stream. So you guys will let the drawing go. That's what I'm going to be doing. I'm going to be doing that later. Tune in for that. Ah, boy. 24 karat magic. That's a good one, too. Because it's mostly talking. Phantom of the Opera. There you go. Phantom of the Opera. Night time. Yeah, I can feel my voice. It's not the best it could be right now. I'll tell you guys what. If one of you can actually get Jazza on the stream, you go tweet him. Say if you can get Jazza on the stream, I will sing right away. I will sing right away if one of you can get Jazza on the stream right now. Jazza or Mark Crilly on the stream, okay? What a deal. But I will sing it at the end. I promise I will sing at the end, okay? Jonathan wants me to sing an All For One song. I want to know, how many of you guys actually know who All For One is? Maybe you guys don't know who All For One is? Let's see here. Brandon wants me to draw a Firestorm from Legends of Tomorrow. Maybe one of these days, for sure. That'd be a lot of fun. Actually, drawing all those Legends of Tomorrow characters, they'd be pretty cool. Really. Let's see. Yeah, if you could tweet them. If one of you could get one of them on here, I will sing right away, and I will sing, like, I will sing Let It Go, I will sing 24 Karat, whatever you want me to sing, I'll sing it. Okay? If you could get one of them on the stream here. But it's not going to be good, I'll tell you that right now. My voice is, I can feel it going already. My voice, because you know it's still in the sick mode. So, Fisher Rogue didn't like my singing. That's fine. Totally fine, man. Jazza liked it, though. We had a good laugh about it. But now you know why I lost all the subscribers at the same time. So. Okay, I'm almost at the point where I'm gonna start actually drawing Rocket Raccoon in here, guys. So we'll get to that soon. What's FNAF? What is that? Not sure. Oh, Five Nights at Freddy's. Yes, yes, yes. You guys been wanting me to do that for a long time. Canadian National Anthem. Huh. All right, guys. Okay, we're getting almost to the end of Baby Groot here, and then we're going to get started doing some Rocket Raccoon. Let me just draw the hands. And I just want to see how I want to draw the hands. It's a game, James. It's a game. Am I going to add a background? Probably not tonight. If anything, I'll probably just quickly throw in a matte painted background. Just because it's quicker at the same time. So, just give me 1 second here, guys. Let me just see how his hand looks. Okay, maybe I'll just give him like a regular hand. Okay, Official Rogue 9, thanks for joining. Thanks for joining in. Cheers. So I'll just make his hands like. I was gonna have them out and all that stuff. I'll just keep it simple at this point. Bye, Ariel, but you're gonna miss my Let It Go. Okay. Oh, not you. No, oh, yeah. I guess we're saying bye to Rogue Nine, right? Yeah, you wouldn't want to miss my Let It Go, would you? All right. So now I'm gonna add my trademark dots. Here, the trademark dots. And all these dots do, it just gives it a little bit of texture. Gives everything a little bit of texture. I learned this technique through looking at a lot of Steven Platt stuff. That's why I like adding a lot of this type of dots and stuff like that. Okay. Right. Okay. Okay, for now, Baby Groot done for now. What do you guys think? Okay, of course I could do, you know, I could put an extra hour of work in them. I really could, but. Let's see here, Diet Coke. Again, cheers everyone, cheers. Maya wants me to sing for her. A little bit later, okay? How you feeling? I would say around 90%, but I'll tell you guys right now, because I'm talking a lot, my voice is, it's going a little bit. Maybe I'm just making excuses already, okay? But no, I can really feel my voice starting to wane a little bit, so it's starting to stress out, but stop sponsoring! I can't help it, I love the Diet Coke. So, I'm gonna go in, I'm gonna actually start drawing the, Rocket Raccoon, so just give me a second here. Oh. Okay. Ariel's crying. Is it because I'm not singing to you too? I'll sing to you too, Ariel. Brandon made some cookies. I want some cookies. Oh, where's my cake? I think my wife went to sleep. Oh boy. Okay, 1 second here, guys. I'll just check this thing quickly because I keep getting these dings. Oh, just keep getting the dings. Alright. Just keep getting the dings. Here we go. Okay. Armando wants me to sing to them as well. Okay, right for you. Okay. Hi, James. Welcome back. Favorite Marvel or DC character? Gotta go old school. Gotta go with the crowd. Wolverine, Batman. Easy. Wolverine, Batman. Can't go wrong with either. Okay, so let me start the Rocket Raccoon part, guys. All right, so I won't be chatting with you. I'll have the chat open, so I'll kind of see what you guys are seeing there. And through the brutal line process, I won't be asking any questions, okay? So if anyone asks why I'm not answering questions, just let them know that's why. And I'm going to go ahead and once I'm done the blue line, once I get the time-lapse version, that's when I'm going to start doing it. Okay, so just give me a second here. Oh, by the way, before I do that, I'll tell you guys what. You guys want to hear me sing? Because I'll tell you right now, I can sing right now, but it's not going to be good. I can feel my voice going. Let me share with you one thing here then, okay? Just for you. Let me see if I can find it here. Hold on. Hold on. Okay, so just give me a second. I'm going to share this with you guys. This is me more at my best and when I was a lot thinner. but I wish I could sing like this. No, I can't right now. I'll tell you right now because of my voice. I can feel it because it's going. Okay, so that's why. Excuses. Let's sing it here, guys. Let's see here. Just give me a second here. Videos. Oh, no. Sorry. Do. 1 second here, guys. Maybe this is not the best thing to show because, okay, I won't say anything, but. One second here. Okay, here we go, guys. I gotta share this one thing with you. Okay. Okay. All right. I'll still try to sing at the end, but this is me singing better. Okay. I can't sing like this anymore. All right. Okay. Let's go. All right. I gotta fill the Rocket Raccoon now. Okay. Let's do that. Okay, so pretty much I'm done with the Groot for now. As you can tell, I added some black here, and I added some cross-hatching just to make sure the light's going around the particular character the way I want it. And then I went in and added my trademark little dots just to add a little bit more texture. But so now I'm going to go ahead and start roughing in a Rocket Raccoon. So I'm imagining, okay, perspective does come into play here. I'm imagining that we are, like, the camera is, like, right close, of course, to Groot's face. That's why he's so big, okay? So it's right near him. So in perspective, Rocket Raccoon is either gonna be like really tall, or maybe I could do a thing where he's kind of on his shoulder. Maybe that would help, and then I wouldn't have to draw as much. that's the lazy way to do it. Let's see. I'm trying to see if I can just do the shoulder. That's not as cool. Let's draw him a little bit bigger. Okay. So what I want to do is make it look like we're kind of looking up at him. Okay. We're looking up at Rocket Raccoon here. Okay. And I want him to be holding a gun. Okay. So I'm going to draw. Go ahead. And just like any regular face, I'm gonna start with a ball. Okay, now pause this for a second. Yes. Okay, guys, just give me a second here. I'm going to get some Rocket Raccoon reference. I didn't even get some Rocket Raccoon reference. Got some Rocket Raccoon reference going here. Hell, have to be Guardians 2. Has to be the Guardians 2 costume too. So let me just make sure I got the proper one going. Let's do concept art. Because at the very least of the concept art, I could get the costume right for the most part. So, 1 second here, guys. I'm just taking a look at this Rocket Raccoon. Ah, this is a nice one. Okay, I found a really nice image to use for the Rocket Raccoon. Try to draw while singing. Thank you guys for the nice comments. That was fun. That was a long time ago, so I cannot sing like that anymore. Alright. Alright here. So okay, I'm gonna go back to the tutorial, then I will answer more of your questions. So just give me a second here, guys, alright? So okay, so now, like, I don't want to go too up on him. Like, I don't want to go too low angle on Rocket Raccoon, and I'll tell you why. Mainly because if I do so, he'll look like a giant. He will look like a giant. So, I might cheat a little bit here and have him kind of, like, size as on the side, and then maybe I could say that maybe Groot is on something just to finish the story. But... well, we'll see how that goes. So in the meantime, I'm just going to go ahead and draw Rocket Raccoon here. And I'm going to start by, again, with the circle. So I'm going to draw a circle here. Okay, and draw a line for the eyes and where the snout is going to go here. Okay, so the snout, again, I'm going to draw it out like I'm drawing a cylinder. Okay, like a short cylinder. That would go back into perspective here like this. Okay, so it's going into the head. So again, I'm still thinking in 3D, even when I'm drawing animals here. Okay, so that might be out a little bit too much. That might be out a little bit too much, so I might want to pull this back. Okay, and just give me a second. I'm just going to adjust the camera a tiny bit. Just going to try just the camera a tiny bit. Just bear with me. Second here. There we go. So... his eyes will be here, so pretty much like we did with Groot, I'm gonna draw his actual full eyeball in here. It's gonna look weird at first, but bear with me, okay? And then I'm gonna draw a plane on top, and that will make his forehead, okay? So if you start thinking of the faces and planes, that would actually help out with a lot of this type of stuff, okay? Oh, that's the correct sign. Correct. All right, so going in here, just roughing out parts of his face here. So I am looking at some Guardians of the Galaxy references here. Okay, and then I'm gonna go ahead and draw the snout or the nose here. I'm gonna try to rough that in. Okay, and again, I'm trying to figure out the planes of the face here, how they would work. Okay, there you go. Have an ear up here, like that. An ear up here, like that. No problem. Okay, and then I'm gonna draw the eye in here. So again, what's really gonna make this drawing is the eyes, okay? I think what actually makes everyone's drawing is the eyes, the way you draw the eyes. Eyes is always something we have to relate to. As human beings, like, we look for something in eyes that make them feel alive, all right? So the way you draw eyes is very, very important. If you're gonna be good at one thing, you gotta be good at a lot of things, but if you're gonna be good at one thing, make it the eyes. The eyes have to feel right, or the rest of the drawing will get lost. So, okay, and then I'm gonna draw the iris in here like this. Okay, so I'm gonna go in and blue line the rest of him, as well as the gun, and then we will go from there. Okay, so let's do that. One second here, guys. Okay, I just have to change the battery on my main camera here. It's Road 1217, guys. Thank you so much for staying with me this long. Probably gonna go another hour and a half. Guaranteed another hour and a half. So please stay with me. Please stay with me, all right? Or you don't have to stay with me like this. I'll probably keep this one up on the main channel for quite a while. So if any of you wanna watch the full stream, I'll actually leave it on this channel. Usually I transfer it over to the James Race channel. Maybe I'll still add that over to the James Race channel, but I'll just keep this on this channel just because we're celebrating 20,000 subscribers. Just give me one second. I'm just going to change the battery of my main camera. So I'm just fixing the camera here, guys. Just give me one second here. There we go. That's even better. It's funny. In the main camera, you can watch me across my legs and stuff. Gonna have to edit that out. Let me go back to the chat here. See how you guys are doing. So. All right. Let me just take a look at. Oh, people are asking how old you guys are. Let's see here. Love anime. Oh, some young guys here. He is young. All right. Do a cheap art supplies challenge. Sure. Well, yeah, I guess these aren't really cheap, right? So, yeah, you know what? I think I will do that. I'll film myself go to the dollar store, just get some markers and stuff like that. It'll be fun. All right, play Pictionary. Yeah, we should play Pictionary. That'd be fun. All right, so just looking quickly at your comments here. Dirks, want to see the rubber duck. Here's the rubber duck, my friend. There's a rubber duck right here. Let's use it to erase. Okay? So, you know what I wanted to show you guys was that I actually have a Rocket Raccoon toy. It's a big one. I just couldn't find it. Couldn't find it in time for the stream. I wanted to show you guys that. So, alright. Thank you guys very much. Thank you. It's great to see that. Like, I find my audience, it's a really wide age range. At first, I think earlier this year, it seemed like my audience was really like in the 30s. It was like mid-20s to 30s. Like, we do have like a lot of you that are younger who were watching at that time too. But it seemed like it was like an older crowd watching. Maybe it was like old Image Comics style guys. But then it's opened up. It's opened up since then. And I'm finding in my analytics that a lot of younger artists are coming soon. Let me just see here quickly. James Ash says, do I have a class? If you're talking to me... If you're talking to me, yes, I teach four, right? I'm gonna have five classes in January. So I'm teaching three matte painting classes a structural drawing class and a perspective class. Okay, and I also teach concept art. I did that earlier. I probably won't be teaching that anymore after this, but yeah. So, you know what is also nice? If you guys could let me know what time it is in your area, wherever you are in the world. I always like seeing that too. So, while we do that, well, in the meantime, I'm going to get this going here. Okay, I'm just recording here, so I'm going to go back with the blue line, and I'm going to start drawing. Drawing me some Rocket Raccoon. Rocket Raccoon. I'm just looking at your tweets here, guys. You guys are funny. They want me to just let it go. You guys are amazing. Thanks. Oh, boy. All right. So, I'm going to go ahead and draw part of his... his outfit here. Now I'm thinking of the gun right now. I do want to draw a pretty cool gun here, and that'd be fun to do. Like, I could keep it simple and just have him like kind of standing here, kind of like just like looking over him, and that would be fine. It would get the point across, but it's not as cool. Or I could have him have like a gun back here, but again, not as cool. Not as cool. I want it to be cool. Yeah, no. It's gonna be cool. Okay, look at all these different times here, all over the world. Look at that. Look at that. All over the world you guys are from. It's awesome. Where do I live? I live in Toronto, Canada. That's where I live right now, so. So it's around 12:23 in the morning right now. So same time zone as MythBusters here, Florida. Love Florida. My cousin lives in Florida. Oh, sorry, my brother-in-law lives in Florida. So we go down there for the winter sometimes. That's a lot of fun. Let's see here. Just see a Rocket Raccoon gun. Rocket Raccoon gun. One second here, guys. Let me just find a nice looking gun here. Woo! I see a pretty awesome gun here. But it is from the older movie. But it's cool. Oh, maybe I will do this. Or what I could do is I could have him holding the one gun here. Like this. It'll just take a tiny bit longer. I hope you guys don't mind. It's a tiny bit longer. Like, he could be holding the one gun like this. And then have the other gun here on this side here like that. Right, could we have the other gun like here like this? Yeah, why don't we do that? We'll do that, okay? So he's gonna have the one gun on the one side, and then the other gun on the other. So let me just make sure I got a clear picture of the gun here so I know how to draw it properly. Okay. Whoops. Why is it like that? Why did it do that? Sorry, my Photoshop's all wonky. There you go. Okay, I got some gun action going. I got some gun action. And let me just get this other piece of reference here, and then we'll get going, guys. Just one second here. Actually. Okay. It's there that I wanted. This one. Sorry guys, just gathering some reference here. I think for the next stream I gotta make sure that I have all the reference ready, because I don't want you guys waiting around for me googling stuff. Okay, that's good. Okay, I can close all this stuff now. Alright! A Nerf gun! Oh boy. That's right. Art connects us all. I love it. Okay, guys, let's not get into any political thingies here. This is not the place for that, all right? Though it is nice to see where everyone's from, though. I love seeing where everyone's from, because that's cool. This is cool. So, yeah, I got the best fans. Got some really nice fans here. Thank you. I agree. This is one of the nicer chats. Mainly because probably there's not, you know, there's only 60 of you online compared to other places, so. So, okay. So again, please, no politics going on into the chat, please. I would really appreciate it if we don't bring politics in. This is not the place for that. This is a place just to have a little bit of fun, all right? So let's do that, all right? Jason, welcome from Australia. Okay. So from wherever you are in the world, cheers to you. Cheers. All right. All right. James, thanks so much for joining in. Really appreciate it. Okay, so right now I'm going to rough in the gun. I will rough in the gun, and then I will go ahead and start inking this guy. Okay, so just give me a second here. I'm going to record this part here. Oh, I was recording the whole time. Recording the whole time. So I'm going to rough in the gun. Whoops. Oh, Aaron, thank you so much. I'm glad you found the channel. Thank you very much. Oh, you're talking more memes. Okay. Right. Okay, so let's see here. So I'm going to go ahead and draw part of this gun here. And it's a very, very interesting gun, so. And the way I'm drawing it, you're probably not going to see all the gun anyway. So, just adding some things. So what's going to really sell this gun is the pipes on it. Pipes on it, and there's got to be some sort of trigger on it. Because this goes around like that. And then we have this part of the gun that goes like this. So if we see that, and then we see his hand, we probably will, it'll be implied it's a gun. It's not like he's not carrying like a whole bunch of pipes, but as long as we see the hand and the part, I think that's enough to kind of sell that's a gun. And then over here we'll have the three barrel gun here on this side of Groot here. I'm not sure if you can see that, because I'm probably, my face is probably covering it, but that's what we will do here. Okay, so for the most part, this part is pretty much blue lined enough for my liking, so I'm actually gonna go in again with the one. Again with the 1 micron, and just start adding in a little detail just so we could see it a little bit better, and then I'll probably go in with a Sharpie, put in the blacks, and then try to tie everything together. So right now, I'm going to go in with the 1, start to put the detail, and then we will go from there. All right. Okay. Art of Paradise, good night, good night. I didn't even know you were on. But thanks for coming by. Why haven't I sang yet? Okay, for those of you who just got to the chat, I'll put the link in again just to tide you over. Oops. Oh, the link's not there anymore. Never mind. Go back in the chat. You'll find a link to me singing, all right? Okay. Oh, boy. Okay, so just give me a second here. Just pulling up the reference. And I'm just going to zoom in here. All right. Let's get some fun going here. So, this will be interesting, okay? Like, I'll tell you guys right now, like, drawing animals is probably not my strongest suit. Like, Mark Crilly does incredible animals. So I'm gonna do my best here. And we'll see how it turns out, okay? Because I do have a tendency to over-render sometimes. But we'll see here. But Rocket Raccoon, he's got like things like fur and all these fun things going on with him, so. We'll see. So again, it's the eyes. It's the eyes. Everything's about the eyes. Okay, and I'm approaching this as if I'm drawing a human. Everything is about the eyes. All right. So we got eyeball here, eyeball. Okay, a little bit of highlight here. That's what that's for there. Okay, so I might actually even go in with a little black already, just because I want to get the feel, because I know if I nail the eyes, I know the rest of the thing is just gravy. It's just gravy on there. Jason, thank you very much. I appreciate that. So. Doritas Webby, well, the top of the morning to you too. Are you Irish? Are you Scottish? Scottish, Irish? Did I just offend you there? I apologize, man. All right. Actually pull the nose back a tiny bit here. Pull the nose back here like that, tiny bit there. Yeah. Vinicus asks, what do you need to tell us comics I drew so we can check it out? Sure. Let's go back in the vault, okay? So I gotta tell you some really, really, really old comics first, okay? So my very, very, very first comic I've ever worked on, my very, very, very first published work, was a book called Neon Cyber. I did 1 3/4 of a page in Neon Cyber of backgrounds, okay? That was my very, very first published work, Neon Cyber number 5 from Dreamwave, okay? So the very first company I worked for was a company called Dreamwave Productions. Back then, what they did was very anime-esque type books. Some would call them rip-offs of certain properties. I'll let you guys be the judge, okay? That's not for me to say. But we did a lot of titles there. So that was my first book, Neon Cyber number 5. And then I did Dark Mind's Witchblade. That was for Top Cow and Dreamwave. So Pat Lee, he did the main pencils for that. And I did the background. So I was pretty much Pat Lee's main background artist. I was his main background artist for about 2.5 years. 2.5 years. So he would draw all the characters and I would do all the backgrounds. And that was the first thing I did. I actually did that while I was in school. So Dark Mind's Witchblade, I'll consider that my first fully real published work. Dark Mind's Witchblade number 1. So for the most part, I did all the backgrounds for sure. And then I did the layouts, and we were falling behind, so he asked me if I could do the layouts. So pretty much I did the layouts, so all he had to do was fill in the characters. So yeah, so from there, I worked on Warlands. I was the main background penciler for Warlands, as well as I was doing a title called Dark Minds. Okay, so Dark Minds and Warlands. I was doing those two titles. And then, let's see, my first fully penciled work that was published. My first fully published penciled work. Oh, my card is full. Just give me 1 second here, guys. Card is full. My first fully penciled work was actually a one-shot for Dark Minds. It was Warlands. Warlands number 0 1/2. Me and my buddy Chris Saracini, we came up with this cool story. And that was my first fully penciled work. They actually let me do the pencils to that work. So that was a lot of fun to do. Okay, so just give me a second here, guys. I gotta make sure, first of all, that all the files are transferred over. I think all the files are transferred over from here. Just give me a second here, guys. I'm just going to transfer the files. Bear with me. After that, then I started my foray into Transformers. Okay, so I did Transformers Armada, number 1-5. Okay, then I did... hold on 1 second here, guys. Transformers Armada 1-5, and then I did a few issues of, I'm trying to remember. A lot of, because there was a lot of Transformers titles I worked on at Dreamwave. Okay, let me get past the Transformers titles. I'm sure if you Google Transformers and James Reyes, you'll find all of them there. Sorry, 1 second here, guys. Let me just transfer the files over here quickly. One second here, guys. So after that, I did a title with Warren Ellis it was, we'll call it my very first Dreamwave work. It's called Tokyo Storm Warning. Now, if you guys look at my channel, I have a video there called my throwback series where I talk about my old art. You can check that out. I talk about my experience working on that book and how I kind of messed that up. So look up for, just search Tokyo Storm Warning James Reyes on my channel. And you'll find me telling you that story. So I worked on that, Tokyo Storm Warning. There was 3 issues of that. And then I also did Star Wars Tales for Dark Horse. Then I did Wonder Woman, issues 212 and 213. Let's see, I did City of Heroes for Top Cow. I did 2 issues of that. I just can't remember the 2 issues. One was for the main title, and then I did issue number 13, if I believe. I also worked on, for Marvel, I worked on 3 titles for Marvel. I worked on, it's called Amazing Fantasy, and we focused on Death's Head over there. And I worked on Captain Universe, Invisible Woman, one shot. And then I worked on, I talked about the Death's Head. I worked on Hulk Destruction. All right. And let's see, what else? And then I went back to DC. I worked on Birds of Prey, issues 98 and 99. And I think that's roughly, yeah, there's more in there. I just my memory's kind of jogged. From there, I went back to school. I went to computer animation, then I worked in film. Now, if you guys want to know what I worked on in film, I'll let you know right now the film I worked on. Okay, so I worked on Stargate. Okay, so if you guys have ever seen that show Stargate, I worked on that show. I worked on the 2 DVD movies, Stargate Arc of Truth, Stargate Continuum, and Stargate Atlantis. I worked on all 3 of them. I worked on a show called Sanctuary. And then I worked on the movie Percy Jackson and the Lightning Thief. I worked on Watchmen. Back in the day, I worked on a movie called Invictus. Let's see, what else? What else did I work on? Back to Toronto, I worked on Abraham Lincoln, Vampire Hunter. I worked on Underworld Awakening. I worked on, more recently, I worked on Furious 7. I worked on Fantastic Four, the really bad one that just came out. So stuff like that. I did a lot of that stuff. So, and there's more. If you want to look on Netflix right now, my most recent VFX work. Oh, where am I recording? I should. Sorry, guys. I just got... I'm talking. So let me just check one more thing, and then we can get going again. Sorry, guys, for taking so long. We'll finish up in 1 second here. So we'll finish up, meaning I'll really get into this drawing here, get it done. So did I design the pod thing in Fantastic Four? No, I did a lot of the lab stuff, all the stuff in the lab. We did a lot of stuff in there. So let's see. What I will do on Watchmen, I created digital doubles for a lot of the actors. So the comedian, I did a digital double of him, so I rebuilt him in 3D. So there was the shot where he's hanging off the of the owl ship. So I built him. I built him in there. So and a whole bunch of things. I did some concept art there. I did a lot of different assets, like different props. Built a lot of those. So that was a lot of a fun job. That was a lot of fun to do. That was one of the more relaxing jobs I did. Sorry, guys, I'm just checking this one footage thing just to make sure I'm not gonna tape over anything I shouldn't be taping over here. Oh, I didn't record. I didn't copy this over, this card. Sorry, guys, 1 second here. Let me just finish copying these cards over. I'm missing a card. Oh, you know what? I think there's a lot of space still on this card. Let me just do that. Actually, no, there's not a lot of space here. One second, guys. Sorry. I thought these cards were cleared. Let me just take it out of this camera here. Oops. Where is it out already? It's out already. Where's my other card? Okay. Well, let's just go with this one until the other card's cleared. For now. Well, yeah, guys, that was my foray into film. Now, if you guys want to see some of my recent work, go check out on Netflix. Go check out Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon. I believe it's called Sword of Destiny. I worked on that. And I also worked on Marco Polo Season 2. So you guys check that out. Those are on Netflix right now. You could go over there and check out some of that work there. And I think the last thing I worked on before I quit my job, I think I could say that now. It was on a movie. It's called The Promise. I'm not sure when that's coming out. If it's getting out, it stars Christian Bale and Oscar Isaacs. So you could check that out. I'm not exactly sure when that's coming out. So if you guys check out the IMDb, you could check out when that's coming out. That was the last project I was working on before I quit my job. So I'm going to be using some gel pen on Rocket here for sure. Thank you, Mike. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Okay. How fulfilling was my time in the film industry? Did I work on things I enjoyed? I enjoyed working in the film industry, and I'll be honest. If all this doesn't work out, I'll be happy to go back. I had a great time working in film. You know, I'll tell you right now. After you worked on a few of the bigger titles, you lose the interest of I want to go work on Spider-Man and all that kind of stuff because you know the type of stuff you're going to be doing, and all that. And sometimes it's mundane things like I'll be working on things like rocks and trees and all that kind of stuff, right? So it's not all exciting things that you're working on all the time. Let's just say that. But I was good at it, and it was a lot of fun. Paid extremely well. Extremely well. So no regrets about going into that. Like, I learned a lot. So if all this stuff that I'm doing now, if it doesn't work out, then I'll be more than happy to go back. Looks like I will have an opportunity to go back. So we'll see. But very, very fulfilling. I really enjoyed my time working on film. So. All right, wait on. Bye, Game Worthy. Bye bye. Let's see here. Mark says, what did I work on in the Crouching Tiger sequel? If you look at that ice sequence, you know that part where they're fighting on the ice? Donnie Yen and the guy who played Bruce Lee? That's what I worked on. We worked on that for months, that particular ice sequence. That was a toughie to do, for sure. So, I'm going to tell you guys right now, this Rocket Raccoon is going to take a while. It will. Let's see here. Just going into here. Hello to my little friend. Dirk says, I'm thinking about getting into 3D modeling. I'll tell you what, Dirk, do it. Do it. And I'll tell you why. Even if you don't, you know, if you want to draw, 3D modeling will teach you so much about things like human form, about the way objects are. So I highly recommend it. It's definitely not a waste of time if you do that. Right? So... Hudo says, why did you quit? Just the short version. I go into the long version. If you check out my Star Wars story, I explain it further. But just say, like, it wasn't because I was unhappy. I was very happy. But there, like, call it a midlife crisis. There were a couple things I wanted to do before I hit 40. So, and I wanted to try. And I'm in a place financially where I am able to do that. Where I am able to try these things. So... my wife, bless her heart, she said, why don't you just go for it? Go for it now. Give it a try. If it doesn't work out, then you could go back. So that's what I did. And that's what I'm doing right now. So you guys get to come along for the ride. So, yeah. So. Am I a good actor? You know, that is one regret, Ariel. That is one regret I do have. I never took drama. You know, I got killed for that on Jazz's channel when I said drama. I never took drama. I never took drama when I was in high school, and now I'm kicking myself because I know I would have had a ton of fun. Am I a good actor? I think I would have had potential to be a good actor, but I never really tried it, really. So... So this is taking a little bit, this is going to take a little longer because I'm having fun. So I'm actually going to shorten his mouth up a little bit. I think I drew his mouth too low. So I'm going to go ahead here, kind of sketch in. As you can tell, I'm really sketching with Rocket here. And mainly because I can. When it's something like fur, it's supposed to look a little bit sketchy. So... So I'm actually gonna darken up these eyes a little bit more. Have a little bit more mystery to them. Okay, now I'm gonna go also start blackening up some of the nose area here. Okay. How many times did I watch Star Wars this week? Just to give you a little well, here's the deal though too, because it's not like I sit down and watch all the Star Wars, because I'm usually doing something when I'm watching them, right? So it's not like I'm sitting down fully concentrating on them. For example, I actually have it playing while I'm driving. Okay, so I'm not watching it. Okay, I'm not a crazy driver here. So I'll have it on. I'm not actually watching it. I'll have it face down, but I can actually hear the dialogue. Okay, and I kind of imagine what's going on. But I do that at least 3 times a day. Okay, so especially now, because I want to get make sure I get everything, right? Because, like, I loved Star Wars as a kid, but I would never call myself, like, the hardest core Star Wars fan. Like, compared to how hardcore people are, right? Like, I don't watch Rebels. I don't watch... I never watched the Clone Wars or anything like that, right? I never read the books. All I have to go by is the movies. So I wouldn't call myself the hardest core Star Wars fan, though I am a fan. So I want to make sure I get everything right at the same time, so... Okay. Seizure art is correct. Art is the art to the soul. Eyes to the soul. Okay, so all this fur here, all this fur. Because I'm the type of guy who loves drawing every single line for fur. I love it. I love it. But sometimes it gets too much, and too much for the eye to bear. So let's see. I'm gonna try to see if I can try to make it a little bit better. What's your favorite thing to do draw when you don't need to make it look good? I don't know. I'm not sure. Because I want to make everything look good. Bye, Seal Mo. Thank you for joining in. Thank you for joining in. And make sure, for those of you who need to leave, no problem. Make sure you catch the, what's it called? Make sure you catch the time-lapse version tomorrow, okay? So, let's go back to my OBS. Just make sure that you guys can see what's going on here. So I know exactly what you're looking at. For those of you who are asking for this drawing, the answer is no. Like, I do occasionally artwork giveaways. I won't be doing one for this one, for those of you who are hoping to expect one. Not for this one. I pretty much sell all my artwork at the end of the day, so we'll see, okay? I'll let you know if I end up selling this one eventually. Mythbusters asked which documentary changed my attitude perspective on film. I think it'd be, like, I don't know one specifically, but I'm pretty sure it's got to be one of those, like, behind-the-scenes VFX ones. And that also helped me drive me to want to become more of a VFX artist. When I saw Movie Magic being made, and how a talent that I have could actually help make that kind of magic. Okay, 1 second here, guys. I'm just going to change the card again. Because the other card's clear, I believe. Just make sure the other card is clear. Oh, not exactly clear. Hold on. Not exactly clear. Let me just throw in this. Oh, wait. Yeah, I can throw that in there. transfer the Millennium Falcon footage there. Johnny says I could. Well, how will I be deciding the winner of the 20,000 subscriber prize? Thank you, CJR, by the way. Thank you very much.
One second here, guys. Oh, the card is full.
Okay, guys, so we'll just take a tiny break just because I need to wait for the card to clear. So just give me a second here. So just to answer your question, what's it called? Hold on. What was I talking about again? the winner of the prize. So what happens was the reason I told you guys to tag me when you share the video, what happens is when I get tagged, I get sent an email. Okay, so and when I get sent in the email, I immediately put that email into a folder. So I have a folder with everyone who tagged me when they shared the video. Okay, from there I go to random.org. And first of all, I count how many emails I have in there. Then I go to random.org, and then I, randomly select a number, and then I count from the top down. Or actually, I flip a coin, whether it start from the top or start from the bottom, and then I will count that many numbers up. And whatever number that is, that person's going to win. I do the check, make sure that they are fitting all the requirements. And then that's how I'm gonna figure out. And then I will contact that person. So that's how I'm gonna do it. Okay, Ulysses? All right? So. I can sell prints. I guess. I'm still trying to figure out the legal way to sell prints online. Like, I know people just do it. But there's gotta be a legal way to do this kind of thing. I also know people who got shut down because they were selling prints of fan art. So yeah, it's one of those type of things. Hudo's playing Xbox. Awesome, Aaron. No problem. The stream will stay up on this channel, so don't worry about that. Who's the most famous person in your contacts? That's a good question. Let me think. I wouldn't call them famous. Like, I know a lot of famous YouTubers. But I wouldn't say anyone who's I wouldn't say anyone who's like a celebrity. I don't think I know any celebrities outright. So, like, I've met them in passing, but I wouldn't call them friends. Okay. Now, guys, like, for example, I know the Screen Junkie guys. Like, they're cool guys. We talk a lot. Guys like that. That's the best you're gonna get. So. Jazza, Mark Rilly. Jazza more than Mark Rilly. I've talked to Jazza on the phone. Mark Rilly, I've never talked to in person yet, right? We've tweeted at each other, but that's about it. So, Bear Sark Lane, thank you so much. Thanks so much. Maybe you could. That's okay. This will stay on this channel, so you can check it out. If you guys want, rewind and check out the great cake at the beginning. So. There is no giveaway on this particular stream, regular randomness, because that took place with the contest. And unfortunately, that contest closed immediately when I hit 20,000 already. So, because that's what I said, and it would be fair to everyone else if that was the case. So, well, I wouldn't call them contacts. I talked to The Rock. Have you guys seen that? The Rock tweeted at me because he liked the drawing I did of his dad. Okay, but I will say Jazz is the one who I probably talk to more personally. Okay, in terms of celebrity contact with me, I'd say The Rock must be the most popular one, all right, or the most famous one. So yeah, all right. Thank you, Justin. Thank you very much. Okay, let's see if this thing is almost done. Demetrius says, "Am I American?" No, I'm not. I'm Canadian. I'm from Toronto. It's close enough. Did he see The Rock cable? I'm not sure. No, he saw the drawing, which is actually not on my YouTube channel. The drawing I did of him and his dad. It was actually a present for his dad. I met him at Hamilton Comic Con. And I gave it to him, and he loved it, and he showed his son. So he said, if you go to my Instagram, you can find that picture. Go to Instagram. So yeah. Yeah, Dwayne's a really, really cool guy. Amazing guy. So, So yeah, so just give me a second, guys. I know we need to get to the drawing. We gotta finish. It's already, what time is it? It's 1 o'clock already. 1 o'clock in the morning already. So, hold on. Let me see how much time I got left on this. About 5 minutes. Sorry, guys. I'm missing one of my cards. That's why I can't. I don't know what happened to it. To the other card. On the floor. So might as well answer your questions. So any other questions, you can let me know. When did I start drawing? Okay, I did answer that earlier. So I started drawing when I was younger. Yeah, round two, professionally last year of high school. Brad Production really wants a shout out. So there's a shout out, Brad Production. There you go. Mythbusters wants to see a comparison of the three types of Spider-Mans. Yeah, that'd be interesting. 6 a.m. for Nathan in the UK. That's awesome. Okay, how about a swig? Here, cheers to you guys. Cheers. Dirk says, should you start with ZBrush? Good question. You can. Absolutely. It depends what you want to do with the Dirks. Do you want to have a model that you could actually go and animate? Then ZBrush might not be the best place to start. I would go with Maya before ZBrush. If you're looking just for something to get you started and the paint over to make concept art, then ZBrush is pretty cool to do. You might be okay starting with ZBrush. But I would learn both. Honestly, if I were you, try to learn ZBrush and Maya, okay? I would learn Maya over 3ds Max, mainly because Maya is used both in gaming studios and in film. 3ds Max, of course, they do use it a lot in gaming studios as well, but Maya is still coming in as well, so that's one of those things. So ZBrush, absolutely. Yeah, both. So Jason Brubaker, I've been following him for quite a while. That guy's pretty cool. And Jason Brubaker, same as me. He was working at DreamWorks. Left a six-figure job to do comic books, right? So really, he was an inspiration for me for sure, too. So that guy's great. Yeah, absolutely. Blender, I haven't really used it, Blender, so I'm not sure. How do you practice scaling down anatomy for smaller perspective comics? Gesture drawing. I approach that the same. I still approach it the same. Draw a skeleton and draw on top of it, so. TF Hero wants another shout-out. Shout-out to you, my friend. Dirk says, what's the standard? Industry standard, I'll tell you right now. Industry standard for film. I'm just talking film. Industry standard for film, Maya. Not so much ZBrush, even. Maya, for texturing, we use a program called... It's on the tip of my tongue here. Mari. Maya, Mari, Photoshop, Nuke. Those are the four if you want to get into film. If you want to do concept art, a lot of people use a lot of ZBrush, however you want to say it. So, Salman Lee, yes, I'm Canadian. Do I like Lee Barramero's art? I absolutely do. That guy's amazing. Love his stuff. Do I have a sketchbook? No, I do not. I apologize. thank you very much. It is around 1 o'clock in the morning my time here. Again, guys, sorry for the delay here. I'm just waiting for my card to clear. Here, that's why I'm actually not drawing right now. So this is done in 2 minutes, it says. So just give me a second here, all right, guys? All right. See if there's any more questions here. So we've been going for about 3 hours, guys. Probably, I'll say we'll be done at 2 o'clock, okay? I'm going to cut this off at 2 o'clock at the latest here tonight, okay? And see if I can grab a piece of cake for everybody, huh? Who wants some cake? Who wants some cake? Vishnu wants a versus drawing between superheroes. That's actually a really good idea. That's really a really good idea. Ariel wants me to sing, like, Let It Go Now. Hold on. Me. Me. Dimitri said me. Who wants cake? Who wants cake? I got to go upstairs and grab the cake. All right. I gotta have a slice of cake before we finish tonight. Oh, you know what? Heck. Okay, guys. Everyone, just stay on the stream. Okay? Just talk to each other. Just give me 1 minute here. I'm gonna go grab a piece of cake. I'll be right back. For sure, my wife's sleeping right now. It's 1 o'clock. So I'll grab a piece of cake. I'll come right back. Here, don't go anywhere. I'll be right back. So just give me a second here. Alright, 1 second. I'll be right back.
Look what I got.
Woo!
All right.
Here we go, guys. I went upstairs. They already cut into the cake. They just forgot to bring me one. Here we go. Some cake. Okay, looks like the card is done now. Finally. Who wants some cake? Who wants a cake? So for those of you who didn't see this, I had this at the beginning, and then you could see here, it says that's a 2 and a 0. It did say 20,000 at the top of this cake. Okay, I'll tell you what you guys want. Let's do this, okay? Who wants cake? All right. Let's put a timer up here. Okay, give me a time. How fast do you think I can eat this cake? How fast do you think I can eat it? How fast? Hey, hold on. I can put a timer. Where's my clock here? Where's my clock? Clock. 1 second here, guys. You grab a clock here. Clock here. Let's go. Timer. Right. How long? 30 seconds? 45 seconds? 2 minutes? 23 seconds. There you go. 30 seconds? Let's do 30 seconds. 20,000 milliseconds. Okay, let's do 30 seconds. Please don't choke. I won't choke. And if I do choke, you guys can call the 911 for me, okay? So, just letting you go. 30 seconds sounds like a lot. Sounds like not a lot, right? Can we do 1 minute? Let's do 1 minute. Or 2 minutes. Maybe 2 minutes. Let's do 2 minutes for 20,000, right? 20,000? 2 minutes for 20,000? Okay. 20,000. All right, okay, let's do... Would that be okay if I did 2 minutes? 10 years. Would you guys be okay 2 minutes like this? I earned 2 minutes. Okay, let's do 2 minutes, okay? Just to make sure I'm alive, okay? I'm pretty sure I can do 30 seconds. I've tried one of those 6 minutes challenges before. I actually tried one of those, what's it called? Ulysses, that's if I was eating pie. All right. What's it called? I tried one of those steak challenges before, you know, like you see those competitive eaters. It was a 69-ounce steak, and I did really well. But around the 30-minute mark, I burned the roof of my mouth, and then I couldn't eat anything because of the salt started rubbing against the roof of my mouth because I ate it so fast. So people thought I was going to finish. But I had to quit 40 minutes in because I was in so much pain at the top of my mouth. So I gotta do that. See, now this is how I got sick in the first place, right? So I guess you guys ready? Here we go. 2 minutes. 2 minutes. All right. Topic of food, what's your favorite? I'd say lasagna. And the reason I say lasagna is because that's the one I cheat the most with. So I'm pretty strong with any other food. But once I see lasagna, I gotta eat it. All right, so. Verst Winston says hi. A lot. Okay. Ready, set. Let's go. Here we go. Oh. I'm going to try not to make this look gross. Okay? I won't eat it like... You know, I don't want to do it with a cake all over the face and stuff. Yeah. Let's see. Let it go. I don't hold about it anymore. Let it go. Shows you guys how much I care about the drawings. Here I stand. I forgot there's background music too, so it probably didn't fit. The fool never bought a man away. Oh, whoa. No problem. I got 30 seconds. Oh, you're done. Oh. I'm in my mouth. Whoa. I have still stuff in my mouth now. I always wanted to do that. I always wanted to, you know, those competitive eaters, they go, when they're done eating the food and all that kind of stuff. I can eat happy now. I totally forgot that was a thing. Yes, I was cheating with the Coke. Sorry, guys. Any cake on the drawing? Alright, I'm not going to go on the drawing. Let's finish this off, guys. Let's finish this off. One second here. Do not become Elsa again, please. 2 minutes, not too bad, right? Yeah. By the way, Bazark, have you seen my video with Furious Pete? Have you seen that? If you guys didn't know, Furious Pete's logo that he has, I believe it's on his vlog channel. If you look at his, it says Team Furious. Have you seen that logo? The black and white logo? That's my drawing. I designed that for him. So if you check that out. Okay, so let me just double check. Make sure that all my files transferred properly. Okay, so that looks fine. Let me just check the Magroot one so that I can take a look at this tomorrow. This footage looks pretty good. Yeah, Furious Pete, he doesn't live that far from me. He lives around, like, he lives in Mississauga, which is not too far from here, about 15 minutes, yeah. So, yeah, we talked. This was way back when I started my channel. We're like 2013. And if you guys look back at my channel, you see me drawing Furious Pete. That was one of my first videos, me drawing Furious Pete and trying to eat donuts. So if you guys haven't seen that, go check out me eating donuts and drawing Furious Pete. Go check that. That's one of my earlier videos. Like one of my I believe that was my fifth video that I ever put out, right? So. Okay, so 1 second here, guys. Let me just clear the card here, and then we're ready to go, finally. Now let's get this thing done. Enough playing. All right, let's get this guy done. Let's get Rocket done. Okay. How long does it take me to upload the full streams to YouTube? You mean on my second channel? It actually takes a while. My internet isn't the best. Could be faster. My internet could be faster. Because right now, I think for those of you who tried to, when I first started streaming, I tried to do two HD videos. Like, so my the camera on me, this camera here was HD, and then the other one HD, my internet said no. So. No, thanks. Wants a donut. Who wants a donut? Who wants a donut? Oh gosh, you guys are the best, you know? You guys are the best. Just keep me entertained. Okay, so let's get this group guy done. Let's get him done. Yeah, I wish I was more into anime, but I'm not really. Even when I was working at Dreamwave, like, those guys loved anime. They're really into it. My kids, they love anime. This wasn't really my thing. Like, you guys watch, like, things like One Punch Man and all that kind of stuff? Like, my friend's been trying to get me to watch One Punch Man for the longest time. Like, I've seen a bunch of, like, Legend of Korra, all this kind of stuff. They're great. Yeah, Avatar. Yeah. Yeah, I've seen a few of those. This is actually a 08. This is a 08, Ariel. It's just this fur because it's, you know, it's fur. It's taking a long time. So I'm gonna start stepping it up here, guys. Just because it's already, what, 118? I wanted to get this done in 40 minutes. So just really start stepping this up a little bit faster. Value Animation Studios, how you doing? All right. Do I have a file for Comic Book Bleed? That is a good question. When I was working at IDW, they actually gave me parameters to exactly how much bleed to give. I just don't remember. It's been a while. So, how much the bleed area should be and all that kind of stuff. So, I'll see if I can dig that up. I'm sure it's in an old email somewhere, but that's a great question. Let's see if I can try to find that. So, oops, I messed up here. Actually, I'll keep this here like this. I messed up, guys. I messed up. But at least there's no cake on here. Brad, I know you want to get a lot of subs, but to be honest, buddy, that's not the way to get subs. Okay. Okay, people sub, well, if they like look at your channel and they like it, man. So just let it happen naturally, dude. All right? Okay. Vinchu, I know you've been asking for a while if I could look at your drawings. I'll be totally honest with you. I have hundreds of people asking me to look at their drawings right now, and I just don't have the time to look at everyone's drawings and give proper critiques. Like, I could look at your drawing now, buddy, and then the most I could say is, like, cool, or, you know, that's pretty much it. Cool. just being 100% honest with you, because I don't want to say I can look at all your drawings and then not be able to follow through. And I have 100 people waiting for me to look at their drawings too. So I wouldn't do it right now. Now is not the best time. Okay. All right. Okay, Vinicus, thank you for joining in tonight. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Okay, so now, guys, I'm just going to go in here and just go ahead and get all the costume details done. Okay, I'm going to actually I'll go a lot faster than what I was doing before. Again, I'm using my theory about the black ink, how black fixes everything. And the same will go for this as well. So, again, mainly because I'm not 100% sure what the costume is, so I'm going to cover a lot of it with black. All right. Go to OzCon. I'd love to go to OzCon. Freehand braveness or freehand craziness? Crazy. By the way, I apologize to those who thought I cheated with the Coke. I apologize. I guess I did. Okay, so let's get the ears done quickly. Wondering what artists you would suggest working under the Ood Unbounder now. Do you mean what artists I like over there, or what kind of artists should work there? Is that what you mean? Because a lot of those Udon guys, they're former Dreamwave guys. So a lot of them are my friends. Really great guy, guys like Joe Ning, he's amazing. Omar is amazing, and he's got a gigantic following. Omar, he's got like over 100,000 on Instagram. Longvo is a great guy. Longvo, I met him at San Diego a long time ago. And I was supposed to background his piece. You know, maybe I'll do that for this channel. I'll show you guys how I would background someone else's work. I'll go try to dig up Longvo's old work, because I was supposed to background it. I never got the chance to do it. So maybe I'll try to do something like that. Let's see. Let's see here. Have you ever done digital drawing? I have. But I am a very traditional type guy. I love the feel of paper, you know, paper and pen. And also there's a secondary market. Again, I've talked about that before. That's why I'll never fully go to fully digital with all my drawings. I love having an original, one-of-a-kind original that, you know, possibly I could sell. But, you know, there's only one of these in the world right now. One of these Rocket and Groot by James Ray's in the world right now. And I have it in my hand. And that's cool, you know. That's one thing you cannot do with digital files right now, because it's too easy to copy. There is no original, so... Yeah, as soon as I figure out the legalities behind prints, selling it online, then I will go for the prints. But we'll see, one of these days, maybe. Ariel, I'm not. Oh, you want me to try that? School Idol Festival. Okay. What kind of game is it? Okay, so now I'm actually gonna start trying to draw in the gun right now. So I'm gonna bring out, I'm probably gonna talk more about this on the camera, but I'm gonna start drawing in the gun. Okay, Vishnu wants a Photoshop tutorial, probably sometime in the new year. We'll do that. Okay. Okay, so as you can tell, I roughed in Rocket Raccoon's costume here, as well as a lot of fur detail. And I had a ton of fun doing this particular fur detail here. But right now, I'm working his costume. Now again, because I don't have a lot of reference for what his costume actually looks like, I will be adding a lot of black to this, kind of to hide areas, so it will look a little bit better in that case. And also, I'm going to start roughing in the gun. To do so, I'm going to be using my French curve to do so, pretty much for lines like this. And for the straighter lines, I could use just a regular ruler, though I can't find mine around right now, so I'm going to go ahead and use my ellipse guide, just the side of the ellipse guide to do that. Now, on this side. Okay, so that's what I'm gonna do right now, and you guys can watch me do it.
All right.
Okay, guys, if I just noticed now, if like it's already 1:30, so I might, you know, talk about cheating. I might cheat a little bit more, and I might not draw the gun on this side anymore. Just kind of have his hand down, and thing here. Or I could do a thing. You know what would be interesting? And maybe I should have planned this out better. Like it would be cool if he was in the hand, if I actually had him in. Now I'm thinking about it, that would have been cool. If I had had Groot in Rocket's hand, like this, so he would have, you see a couple paws. Maybe I could still do that. We'll see. Okay, in the meantime, I'm gonna get this part of the costume done first, the gun, and then I'll see if I could do the hands in there. So, do I know Jeffrey Cruz? No, I do not actually. Jeffrey Cruz. That sounds familiar though. What has he worked on, Jeffrey Cruz? Oh, thank you, Martin. Thank you very much. Do I have a drafting desk? Yes. Oh, Kim Jong-gi. I love that guy. Love the guy's work. Amazing. I just have a regular drafting table. I've had this forever. I've had this ever since I was doing technical illustration back in the day. So this desk is older than a lot of you guys. So this is like... So I would say 1999, around there. That's when I got this desk. Thank you, AJ Gaming. Thank you very much. Cookie, thank you very much. How much did the table cost you? I don't remember. Back in the day? Well, my parents bought it for me a long time ago, so it wasn't me. But I know it could have been more than like $100 back then. But I remember back in the day, I would draw everywhere around the house. I wouldn't just draw here on the desk. I would draw kitchen, I would draw in the, you know, I think like a lot of you guys, I would draw, you know, the dining room, table, so I would leave a trail of papers too around everywhere, so leave a stack of papers around whenever I would draw, so. So I want to thank you guys. How many of you were here for the whole stream? I want to know about here for the whole stream. That'd be interesting to know. Were any of you actually here from the beginning? When you saw me with the full cake? Oh, Jean Bonjou. Here from the beginning. Black. There we go. Oh, Mythbusters, that's right, in the beginning. Jonathan makes the cake. Ariel did see everything, so thanks, guys. Jean Bonjour, thank you very much. I appreciate that. Thank you. And thank all of you guys, whenever you guys came on the stream. Thank you very much. I really appreciate you guys coming on here and celebrating with me. It's been a lot of fun. This was one of the funner ones. I am working on trying to condense these, you know, try to make these live streams a little bit more of a show. But it is nice also to have these type of streams where I could just sit down and talk to you guys. Because I really do enjoy that. Really do enjoy talking to you guys. But I will, I think I might do all the challenges now live. Because it would be fun. I think I could knock out a challenge video probably in about, say about an hour. So top, so it would be like really nice, concise, like a TV show type thing, right? What kind of background do you think would go here, guys? Space? I'm thinking space. Just keep it simple. Like a space type background. What do you guys think? Chamba's good. Chamba's really good. Let's see here. Let's see. Thank you guys for seeing everything. I really appreciate that. Yeah. Just taking a look, a quick look here. Right. Okay. Oh, thank you very much, Ariel. I appreciate that. Thank you very much. Evan Almighty says, have you done the 10-minute, 1-minute, 10-second challenge? Absolutely, and that video is why I got to 20,000 so soon. That is the only reason why. That video is my most popular video right now. I think it's about 80,000 or something like that. You know, which isn't a lot like compared to everyone else, of course, but for me, that's a ton. That's a ton of views for me. So, I'll take it. I'll gladly take it. Am I not sick anymore? I'm about 90%. 90%. Alright. Nightclub background. Oh boy. Humberto Ramos is a fantastic, he's a fantastic artist. Love him. Love his stuff. Of course. Who doesn't know Humberto Ramos? Cliffhanger? No. Love his stuff. Love his stuff. Okay. I am very, very tempted here, guys. I am very, very tempted, but I don't want to do it because I'm very, very tempted to add more black to this thing here. But it's already looking pretty good, so I don't want to ruin it. But at the same time, it's not matching down here, this part here. Mm-hmm. Okay, so let me just outline Groot. I'm gonna get to the gun, and then we'll finish this puppy off here. There. Okay, cool. All right, let me just get the gun in, and then we'll call this a night. All right, guys, let's get this gun going. So I'm gonna go with the 8. I'm gonna go with the 8 Let's start. All right, let's see here. Thank you, Ariel. Thank you very much. Like, I don't like leaving things half done. Last night was... I hated leaving the Millennium Falcon half done last night, but I was really tired, too, at the same time. So, I don't want to do that again. So, let's see. Do I like Richard's friend's work? Not only do I love his work, he inked my stuff. If you check out my covers for Tokyo Storm Warning, Richard Friend inked all of them. He inked all of that stuff. It's like one of the best inkers I've ever worked with, Richard Friend. That guy's amazing. Yeah, I got about 45 people on the stream right now, and honestly, I'm surprised that you guys stayed on this long, for sure. You didn't have to. I really appreciate you guys celebrating with me. That's okay. Okay, but we're almost done here, guys. We're almost done. Let's get this. Let this guy finished. Finished. I gotta take liberties with this gun here, guys. Just because I want to finish on time, and I'm not gonna get it 100% accurate. Because it really doesn't have to be, in all honesty. To me, it's just gotta kind of feel like a gun. So. Let me just make sure the main camera's still going, guys. Give me 1 second.
Yep.
All right. Have I drew Godzilla before? Kind of. If you guys check out Tokyo Storm Warning, I drew someone that kind of looks like Godzilla. It's pretty much Godzilla. So yeah, if you guys check that out, that's there. Okay, so. So again, guys, I probably won't do another celebration. Like, of course, I live stream every week, but I probably won't do another celebration until maybe I hit 50 this time. So. When I hit a goal, then that's reason to celebrate. So, this was my goal. That's why we went for 20. So. Evan Almighty asks, what is the policy on selling work based on a copyrighted character? If I knew... Well, I'll tell you what you can't do. Guaranteed. You can't make your own comic book, of course. You can't do anything like that. You can't make any merchandise off that character legally. Okay? And why should you be able to make money off that thing without the owner knowing, of course? Now, in terms of original art. Now, some say that's different because it's original art. I don't know where the... And I'll be honest with you guys. I don't know where the fine line is for all of that. But... As far as I know, like if it's an original art commissioned piece, they're okay with that for some reason. I guess just because they don't make, you know, they know we're not making gangbusters here off original artwork. But for the most part, they're okay with it. But if you think about it, you know, there are people who buy rights to poster art. That's why the whole print thing I'm still confused by. Like me personally, I'm confused by. And until I know for sure it's legal to sell. Prints, that's why I don't have any prints that I sell online. And once I figure that out, then, you know, then by all means we could do that, right? But we'll see. But there's so many people on YouTube, like, you know, doing things with, like, not just drawing, right? But making videos with characters, you know, all that stuff. And they're profiting off it, right? They're definitely profiting off it. Like, they're still monetizing their videos. So, I don't know where the line is, guys. I really don't. I wish I did. Adrian, that's okay, Adrian. I'm glad you're here anyway. Thank you. Ulysses says, when did the stream end? Probably in about 15 minutes, guys. Won't keep you that much longer. I'm almost done here. Oh, this arm looks kind of wacky. Okay, see, as you can tell, guys, I'm not worried about things like this. Oh, you don't even see it on the stream. Let me just bring it over a little bit. I made a mistake on the elbow, little elbow here. But I'm not too worried about it. So I'm going to go ahead here and I'm going to start blacking in some of these areas here. Again, even just freehanding it. So if you guys are doing anything during the day tomorrow, I might live stream me try to finish off that Millennium Falcon. I might do that tomorrow. So you guys can join me on Facebook Live tomorrow if you guys are around. In fact, I'm going to probably start live streaming a lot of my Star Wars stuff on Facebook. These live streams, we'll keep these to the official live streams. So, but once in a while, I'll jump out to Facebook and do those particular live streams. So one thing, guys, so if you're being quiet, I'm just trying to finish off. Ariel says, what's your favorite genre of music? I'm an older guy, right? 90s R&B. That's what huge Boyz II Men fan. Huge. Boyz II Men fans, so I don't even know if some of you don't even know who Boyz II Men is, but those old love songs, you know. Okay, so. Gotta salvage this arm somehow. Okay. No Backstreet Boys? I plead the fifth. Some Motown Philly, that's right. That's why. I was kinda sad none of you guys knew who All For One was. All For One is pretty much a wannabe Boyz II Men type group, so. Yeah, that's right. We belong together, and you know that I'm right. Why do you play with my heart? Oh, why do you play with my mind? Sorry, my voice is gone, guys. Said we'd be forever. Said it'd never die. How could you love me and leave me and never say goodbye? Well, I can't sleep at night without holding you tight. Girl, at least I must try. Just break down and cry. Pain in my head, oh, I'd rather be dead. The voice is gone, guys. Voice is gone, I apologize. Spinning around and around, although we've got to the end of the road, still I can't let you go. It's so natural. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Okay, that was enough. Sorry, guys. Thanks, guys. You guys are great. Okay, so we're almost wrapping up here, guys. So I'm just doing things like adding cracks and all that kind of stuff. Let's finish this off. Yeah, my wife's in bed. She heard it. Yeah. She unsubscribed. Thanks. Love it. So I'm not going to sing again until the 50th subscriber party, okay? 50,000 subscriber party, okay? Now you won't get me to 50,000 subscribers, thanks. Let me see if I can still do the hand. Okay, so I'm just going to try to do the hand, and then we'll go there. All right. I think they do think I'm a drug on Diet Coke. That's probably true. It is the cake. It's the cake, guys. It's the cake. I think if I just do these two fingers here, if I do these two fingers here, I might get the point across. We're gonna need three. No, it has to be in front of the hand. It has to be in front of the hand, or it's not gonna work. You know, actually, guys, to be honest, I actually did try out for Canadian Idol. I did. Way back in the day, 2003. I gotta tell you guys that story. Maybe I'll do that in a throwback episode. I'll do that for you guys. I'll tell you guys that story. Because that's a pretty good story. I think Jonathan knows that story. One second. Okay, guys, we're almost done. We're almost done here. And in all honesty, if I don't like these fingers, I'll just digitally take them out. So I'll see how they look digital. And then we will go from there. But in the meantime, let's just finish this off so we can finish off the stream. And so I can thank each and every one of you guys for joining me tonight. Really does mean a lot to me, guys. Thank you so much. Thank you, Did. Yeah, so I will tell you guys my Canadian Idol story. I'll do that in a separate video. And that is one of my better stories, okay? I can't tell you that's one of my better stories. You know what? I'll even do that this week. How about we'll do that? We'll do that this week. Oh, why don't I use a little whiteout? That's a good idea. Maybe I will. Thank you, Seizure Art. Just for fun. Let a little bit of whiteout here. Though the whiteout would have worked here would look better up here if I what's it called? If I add more black to his face. So, oh, you can't see the hand? Don't worry, it's not much to see. It doesn't look that great, actually. So I'm just gonna go ahead and add a little bit more here, a little bit fur here. and a little bit of fur here just to kind of blend this a little bit better together here like this. A little bit here like this. Oops, I smudged the whiteness. Okay, I forgot to talk about this during my... Okay, so let me just do a quick ending here, and then we'll go there. By the way, Mythbusters, you've been asking before, have I seen the Dunkirk trailer? I have not yet. I'm actually very excited to see it. I haven't seen it yet, so... Okay, so I went a little bit further. So I filled in all the blacks here. And as you can tell, I just tried to outline all these specific areas here and then just added a little bit of scratches here and there. I did attempt to put his fingers here, though I'm not sure if I want to keep them or not. So when you see the final image, probably right now, you'll know if I kept those fingers in or not. But then I also went with a gel pen and started to add in just a little bit of details here and there. So there it is. That is Groot, Baby Groot, and Rocket Raccoon. Hooray! Oh boy. What's the music? I'm actually not sure. Let me check here what music you're listening to here. So, all right. Okay, so let me turn off the music here quickly. So I just realized I was singing with you guys listening to this magic. This one's called Magic Forest, this music here. But anyway. Okay, so let me just take this camera off here so you guys can actually see this full. Let me just take this camera off here so you guys can see this full. Oh, hold on. Okay. Okay, here we go in here so you guys can actually see how it looks here. Okay, so that is Groot and Rocket Raccoon right there. Right there. This was a lot of fun, guys. A ton of fun. I want to thank you guys for... whoever suggested it, I forgot. So, thank you. This was a lot of fun. So, just so you could see the fingers. I'm not sure if they work. Actually, now looking at it, I will probably see part of that arm. So, I might spend a few more minutes just to try to correct that up. But, we'll see. So... That is it. So you guys will see the time-lapse version on this video tomorrow. Plus, I will announce who won the 20,000 subscriber contest. So yeah. Okay, so there it is. There it is. Thank you so much for following along. How long did this take? The stream was 3 hours and 40 minutes. So if you take away all me talking and yapping and singing... So probably I would say around 3 hours this took me. So thank you very much. Thanks for coming along, guys. You guys are amazing. You guys are a lot of fun. And especially for subscribing to my channel, really, really means a lot to me. And for all of you who actually sat here for 4 hours watching me draw, that's pretty amazing. Thank you, guys. Thank you guys so much. Cheers to you. One more time, cheers to you. I'm not sponsored, but if they do sponsor, I hear they pay good money. I almost spit coke all over the drug. What a way to end it. Thank you. I love you guys, too. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I really, really appreciate it. So, Ariel, Helen, Bearzark, Regular Randomness, well, thanks for joining in. Martin, thanks a lot. Hoodoo Gaming, thank you. Of course, my buddy Jonathan, thank you very much. Tyranny, thank you very much. Mythbusters, yeah, probably 2 hours of drawing. Yeah. Keeman, thank you. Love you too, Ariel. Seizure, laugh out loud. Jordan, cheers. Ravenclaw Tom, thank you so much. Evan Almighty, Evan Q, thank you. John Bonjour, thank you so much. Vishnu, thanks a lot. Sky Shadow, thank you very much. Dirks, again, thank you very much. Ravenclaw, thank you again. All you guys, thanks so much. Josh, thanks. Thanks. I'm glad my voice kind of held up. My voice held up today, so I appreciate that. So, don't worry. The dislikes will come, Ariel. Don't worry. I think I always have two guys. There's two guys who dislike everything I do. I fully believe that. There's just two guys who do everything, dislike everything I do. That's totally fine. If they don't like it, yeah, by all means, tell me you don't like it. No problem. No problem here. As long as they're honest. Okay. That's fine. If they don't like it because they actually don't like it, cool. That's totally fine. I don't mind that at all. If they don't like it just because they want to be a jerk, that's different, you know? So, again, thank you so much, guys. I really appreciate it. So this is one stream I'm actually going to keep on the main channel. I probably will also upload it to the second channel as well. But thank you guys for following along. This was a lot of fun. So if you missed anything, guys, it will be on this channel. So you can go back and then try watching it. Try to tie a full Windsor before ending the stream. I could. Don't want me to do that. Anything you guys want me to do before I end the stream tonight? Okay, thank you guys. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Thank you so much. And I'm glad you like the background music too. If you want later, all of that is royalty free music, and I will have links with that in the description. I have to list the whole thing because that's part of actually using it. Eat more cake. It's upstairs. Oh, sing 24 karat magic. I don't know all the words. 24 karat magic. If you ever leave me, baby, leave some morphine at the door. I don't know the words. I don't know the words. And I'll take with me the memories to be my sunshine after the rain. 'Cause it's so hard. Whatever. High five, everybody. High five. Thank you very much for coming. Thank you very much. Yeah, if you want to leave a like, by all means, peace. Heart gox. Sing, I'll make love to you. Close your eyes, make a wish, and blow out the candlelight. For tonight is just your night. We're gonna celebrate all through the night. Pour the wine, light the fire. Girl, your wish is my command. I'll submit to your demands. I will do anything. Girl, you need only ask. I'll make love to you like you want me to, and I'll hold you tight, baby, all through the... That's enough. That's enough singing before everyone unsubscribes. Thank you, guys. High five to you all. I love all of you. Thank you guys for joining in tonight. That is the last time you're going to hear me sing till 50,000, okay? You want to hear me sing again? We'll go to 50,000, all right? Or if I happen to get to Australia, if I ever get to Australia, probably not this year, not 2017, but I'm hopefully the end of 2017, early 2018. I'd love to go to Australia, and me and Jazza, we talked about it already. We're going to go hit a karaoke bar, or we're going to do some carpool karaoke, that type of thing. We can do that together. So, ooga chugga, ooga chugga. That's from Mythbusters. Thank you very much. Thank you, guys. I better end this. I could talk to you guys all night long. It's 2 o'clock in the morning at my time. So, thank you, guys. Peace out. Good night, everyone. Good night, everyone. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you so much, guys. Love all of you. Thank you so much for 20,000 subscribers, for all the support. Means a lot to me. I'll be on Facebook again tomorrow and back onto the regular streams the next week. And we'll see how that goes. Okay, guys. Thank you so much for joining in. I love all of you guys again. Thank you again for the support, for 20,000 subscribers. My name is James. I'm the Box Office Artist. Let me just do my sign off for all of you, okay? Please follow me on Twitter, Snapchat, Instagram, @BoxOfficeArtist, Facebook.com/TheBoxOfficeArtist, Twitch.tv/BoxOfficeArtist, and my name is James. I'm the Box Office Artist. I'm here to say keep drawing, and I'll see all of you guys next time.